All right, I'm here. We're here. I'm late. I'm fucking late, but I'm here.
Up forward four, hitting behind. As he jumped over forward, you know. Trying to get himself away from that wall. Back 4-3.
It's okay.
He didn't actually go for the heat dash, though.
I'm here.
Oh. Yeah, damn, heat smash. No, we could have closed out. Done.
Whoa. The
nice.
Good block.
Goodness.
Oh, my gosh.
All right, Nobi one round away from evening it up.
Dude, they are locked in, bro.
They are playing Tekken right now. They're gaming. Here we go. We got a breakable floor. Is he going to break it?
Dude, they're playing like, obviously they're playing defensively too, but it seems like they're committing way more to offense than defense.
They're playing like they hate each other, man. It's crazy. They're breaking both floors here, Nobi.
You think I won't finish the string? I'll do every string. All the hits. They're all coming at you.
He still has heat available as well. Going to pop it. Nobi looking so good. We might be going to a final game, guys.
It's looking like they're in Aberdeen. Flash duck while standing 1-3. He's trying to make this comeback. Found an engage, but no great health.
Yeah, no recoverable health there. Goes to the next. Oh!
But look at the health. He's all caught up.
Go to the down jab. Nice. What's going to be the mix? Good back dash. Nice jab. Keep out. Ladies and lads, we're going to a final game. Pakistan versus Japan.
This is tense. Brother, and here we go. Yamasa Yu on the stage to coach Nobi. Wow.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
All right. Off this.
Yeah, and Nobi's just not like, yeah. He already knew.
Bear
here
with
we
me.
Go. Ortiz Farm.
We're here.
Coming for game number three to see
we're
who
here.
Gets into the top six tomorrow.
No one's really been giving both these guys any problems, you know, this tournament so far. This is the first adversity they faced.
And finishing Nobi. The strings, bro. They're just hitting all the buttons. They're like, yeah, I'm finishing it. You think I won't?
That's it, man.
I commit too.
And look at this quick start here for Nobi. Down two, gonna catch the sidestep. Nobi takes the lead.
Man, I wish I knew what you said to him. He's like, finish all strength, bro. You got this.
It's all right. Okay, here we go. Day two of Evo. Starting off with some Tekken. That's probably the only thing that I'm going to be watching today, actually.
Stay down. Get up kick from Nobi. Good choice.
Yeah. Okay.
Get smashed, though.
Going to bank that damage. Doesn't have the heat available anymore. Whoa.
Oh, my God.
Jesus.
Down two.
All right, one round apiece, one game apiece, all even Stevens here.
Yeah, it's way too evenly matched in a mirror match, no less. Good block, only a wild set of one.
Didn't go for the launcher. Wasn't ready. Gets a jab float as well, going for the one.
Go for the launcher. Gonna go for the launcher.
The bolting dash are crazy right now. All right, Nobi activating the heat first, finds the back one to be heat dash combo now.
Yep.
Get to the wall here, I think.
Oh, definitely, man. It's a heat dash combo, which means you get extra hits from the side wall. Save
him! Oh my god, nice sidestep from Artem. Gets the wall set of his own.
And that's going to be big damage as well. He'll have heat available for when Nobi wakes up.
Hey.
Rage available. Gotta be careful.
Yeah, hey, we. Man, heat and rage both available.
Oh my god!
He's going to survive, though.
He will survive, but it's going to be one mix to kill.
He's going
to
wake up with heat available still. So he can still do a heat dash situation. Maybe a heat smash if he wanted
but that's
to.
Is it too obvious, though? Is it too obvious?
I don't care. Just go for it sometimes, bro.
Oh, God.
Step.
Oh, my God. Yes, heat and rage available. Going straight for it.
Oh, my God.
What is going on?
I'm not even paying attention.
They're scrambling my brains right now.
This is insane. I think Artiv is going to get that
Took
round.
And hold it down.
To set point.
Oh, boy. Set point, Artiv, as you just said. Can he close out Nobi to make it to the top six? Winner side of the bracket. Combo's not going to convert.
Doesn't get a punishment low as well. Nobi down two, catches the sidestep. No duck in the string.
God, you're so wild.
Goes for the slide, catch the sidestep as well.
Dude, they're just finishing it.
Oh, my God.
Good timing on the heat burst. Artiv looking at the backboard, doesn't find it. No heat. Combo for him.
Oh, the second hit caught him. The second hit caught him. Nobi gonna take this to the wall. He's gonna big damage.
Heat and rage for us.
Big damage. Big damage. Okay. I'm gonna pay attention. I'm paying attention now.
Final round. Nobi versus Artiv to get on the winner's side of top six. 1-2-1. Artiv engaging.
Yeah.
Gustavka goes for the down jab just to shut that pressure off. He has heat available. There it is now from Nobi. Heat burst. Whoa.
Get off me.
Oh, we're brawling. We're brawling. Down two.
Heat smash Artiv with a huge lead.
Oh.
Nobi heat and rage. Heat and rage. What a side roll. Side roll to the wall. The pixel.
Damn.
Gonna do it.
And a big pop up there.
Damn.
Artiv but gonna take it over Nobi in the final round. What a set. What amazing sets we're having here for our top six qualifiers.
Oh my goodness. That was wild. I've never seen two players of the same character play with that level of aggression towards each other. in that way. That was so fun.
That was fun, yeah, because that was a clash of styles, right? I mean, you know, have Arte always been known to be that kind of guy who likes to take risks, likes to be aggressive. Nobi, on the other hand, as well. Nii even was saying, you know, you have the Japanese playstyle, then you got the Nobi playstyle. It's very different from Japan, right? And having those two clash with the same character, amazing stuff, man.
That was
all right. I'm going to keep it here on second for a while.
Arte qualifying, KSK qualifying. Means we might get that CEO run back in the top six.
Yeah, we might, man. Guys, there's still more tournament action here to come. We're going to be finding out
what else is going on. I think I have Street Fighter 6 right now, yeah?
And we'll be back with some more top 24 action here at EVO 2024.
You're really making all of this by hand.
Goddamn. Chipotle.
The are hand mashed, the chips are hand tossed, and everything is made fresh.
You make it fresh.
Everybody even like Chipotle?
Yes, every day.
I've had it a couple times.
The Chipotle way is we make it fresh every day.
Sounds delicious.
Dude. Why'd you put your new rig in the basement?
Didn't you hear? Bill's a good billionaire now.
Basically, my new connection is...
Okay, I lied. Let's...
check it out.
Well, I don't know. Rocker, I don't know who's got some... Everybody's talking right now. Not enough gameplay showing.
Gamer's Throne.
Well, there's gameplay from... Guilty Gear Strive, but I'm not really interested in Guilty Gear.
Walking downstairs.
I get it.
That's smart.
Live like a Gagillionaire with low latency everywhere. AT&T Fiber with AllBuy.
Do you want okay FGC merchandise by okay FGC artists? Well, you're in the wrong ad if so, because here at 10-0, all we got's the best FGC merchandise by...
Damn, what was that? FGC what artists. Is this merch?
Just look at all this great merch. You can make this your whole wardrobe. I should know.
Mokujin hoodie? God dang it, this is so small. Mishima? What is that? Hang on. That's, what is that?
Just look at all this great merch. You can make this your whole wardrobe. I should know.
Mishima jersey? Oh, that jacket's kind of cool.
Our 10-0 merch booth will be open all 3 days at
EVO 2024.
If you're not here in person, visit us online.
What else did you guys have?
AT&T Fiber with AllBuy.
Sorry, I'm just looking.
Do you want OK FGC merchandise by OK FGC artists? Well, you're in the wrong ad. It's
Akuma Heaven Windbreaker. It's a windbreaker? It's cool, but I'll pass. Oh, wait a minute. The mouse pad. I saw this the other day. I thought it was this was a cool thing. From Street Fighter 3. Anything else?
You can make this your whole wardrobe. I should know. I have. Arteno merch.
This jacket's cool. This thing is a waste. Jersey's okay, I guess. I don't know. Okay. Anyway, Astrobot.
At Tekken 7 does, yes, it is.
The players, bro. The players, you know, right. Talking to, I forgot who it was earlier, but we were talking about the storylines in Tekken right now, right? You either think about how the storyline of Tekken 8 is going to be from start to finish, but you can really think of it just as the player story.
Come on, can you just stop?
How they're transitioning from Tekken 7 to Tekken 8. I like that
just
better,
stop.
Much better. And that's what we're seeing.
Just stop.
Players grow. You know, we're seeing guys like God doing as well as, yeah, just got eliminated by Jimmy J. Tran.
Yeah,
he's still alive. Still alive in Tekken 8.
Jimmy's
I didn't expect
here,
that.
Man. That's crazy.
Right,
dude.
And we got guys like Rhythm taking out players like Tacoma. Like, Rhythm is ridiculous. You got AK, you got Tacoma. Who
and
else?
Now Trizzy.
And now Trizzy as well. Yeah. So Rhythm's still in it as well. Getting closer and closer to that top 6 potential.
In minus.
That's been a crazy matchup, right? But we are staying in the winner's side, guys. And we're going to talk about our next matchup that's going to come. It's going to be CBM. KDF CBM. Going up against
I need to get some water. I didn't prepare well for this stream. I just like grabbed all a bunch of stuff and just like, all right, I'm gonna start streaming, and then I realized I forgot my water. Water is important, ladies and gentlemen.
Arslan still winner side qualifier for top six.
He's looking for the five time.
Of course.
Five times.
If I'm the player that had to play against this guy now, when he's this close, I'm like, oh crap, this is not good for me. Like, when you're playing in pools or something, it's like, it's so far away, he's not really thinking about trying to win it. But at this stage, Arslan's thinking about trying to win it now.
Yeah, no, for sure, man. I mean, look, if you've already won four EVOs, you know the formula. You know what you got to do. You know how much grind you got to put in, and there he is.
See, right, here we go.
Sitting down. I don't know if
next match, next match.
Plays, like,
I think this is top 24 now.
In tournament yet. I
if
know
I said that, then
seven, you know,
I say it again. It's top 24 now.
I believe it was Arslan versus CBM. CBM actually won that one.
I think grand finals tomorrow, which I am probably going to be streaming all of finals tomorrow. Had some plans, had to cancel. So now I'm free. Let's do this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
It was not even the right game.
Yeah, it was the Tekken 7, and he used it this, and he managed to take it.
That's Cape Town not coming until the end of the year for Tekken World Tour. You're right.
Oh, it's Ash.
I think he wants to go there, too. I think he's actually already booked
it. Yo, the what is it called? The fight stick?
Ash missed four times.
Let me see if I can bring it up. The fight stick that they came out for Tekken 8.
He's trying to get fight. One whole hand, bro. With Evo titles. Soon they have to use two. But this is in a great position. Look, getting top 6 minutes aside, that's a great position for you, man.
Oh, yeah. Look at this crowd, bro. Look at this Evo crowd right here. Again, this is just
a bunch of stinky-ass guys.
Yeah.
Look at it, we got Knee, Joke up there.
Drive, yes.
And a couple of ladies, too. She looks like she's having a good time, but most of the ladies, they're like, man, I guarantee you most of them are like, man, I got dragged to this shit. What the fuck am I doing here? I'm surrounded by a bunch of smelly-ass guys. What is this, video games? What the fuck? Well, as long as I'm with my boyfriend,
and he, you know,
it's fine. I'm bored as shit out of my mind right now.
You
better be getting me some In-N-Out after this. I'm kidding, obviously.
He could have won more. I honestly think he could have won more.
Oh, where is it?
A tough task ahead of him.
Come on, before
it's going to be the Nina versus Jin. He has the Elisa, and I know CBM hates Elisa. That is one character that he just wouldn't stop talking about to me. He's like, man, just out of nowhere, we'd just be sitting chilling. He's like, man. But I wonder, is Arslan going to be ready for that? Is he going to go for that character? And one of the reasons is because Elisa's movement
is difficult
to deal with, right? Her backdash, her sidewalk can get around a lot of moves that Jin usually gets away with other characters.
Get out of here.
And I know that Arslan recently won a tournament with the Elisa.
Look at this.
Right now, Nina, Elisa, we'll see which one you'll pick.
Maybe Arslan's going to pick Law. He's hovering it. Oh, come on.
It's part of the new Nike Tekken collaboration. It looks fucking sick. I want one. And it's a PlayStation 1 also. How much is this shit? Let's get it out of the way. They're about to start their match. I might. Oh my god, dude. I have to stop. I gotta stop, but it looks cool as shit.
We're starting off in Paris, lads. Here we go.
Pakistan, look at that. That's so cool.
Arslan, Ash, let's go.
Anyway. Oops.
2-1-4. Early for CBM here.
Yep. And Nina can be such a dangerous character. Both these characters really have a very complete move list, right? But Nina, at any range, can be such a threat.
It's funny, like, watching this is almost like watching Tekken 7 again after that Novi Antif match.
they're playing quite quick, but not as quick as those guys are playing, man.
The way those guys play is crazy.
I'm telling you, they were playing
CBM's got the Jin, Ash has got the Nina.
That was crazy.
You know me, I'm pulling for Jin right now.
Just to go over the, under those highs.
What sucks is that there's a lot of better fighters.
It's a
Tekken 8.
Slow and steady wins the race. First round, just to download, obviously.
Yep. Right now, a lot of pressure. And this is what Nina can do, but he drops the combo. The QCF one counter hit.
And wait a minute, is it exclusive to... Man, I need to pay attention. Holy shit.
Couldn't combo from that one. CBM now has an opportunity, but the power crush comes in. Arslan so aware of when he needs to use it. Big punish.
Boom, 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 boom. Because I'm...
He activated.
Oh, bombing though. Ooh. Step on it. Arslan, 2-0 right now.
It's the timing. We haven't really seen anyone do that to CBM, right? It's the timing. He knows exactly when CBM wants to come in.
I mean, honestly, CBM's not really attacking a whole lot yet. Mm.
Two rounds in quick succession here for Arslan Ash. CBM on the back foot, it seems. It's all set.
Yeah, Max wins the down to that time. But look at that down back for Nina. Look at the range on it. Mm.
There's the
damn.
Once again, he engage up. Try to go for
that parry.
Oh my god, get back out there.
Jin's parry is so godlike.
Gonna be a nice combo.
You can immediately follow it up with anything.
Down for a good counter with throw broken.
Still breaking the counter hit throw.
Long bombs.
Flips him over. What's gonna be the Oki? Go to the plus range. Rage available and heat available for CBM.
He tried that move.
18 seconds left on the clock. Goes for the down two. Rage available. CBM, what are you going to do for us? Go to the range on the press.
No way.
Nope.
Ash, 3 rounds straight for game number one.
Wow. Wow. Okay. Again, CBM looking so strong. And low high. coming to give CBM some advice.
He's not KDF. Damn. This is Korean pride right here. This is sick.
100%, man. Look,
what the hell?
We've had this before. We had this situation before where it's Pakistan versus Korea.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, Arslan Ash, that was a three-round straight, no-round brown for him. Lohai giving some advice to CBM. Let's see if he can turn it around. We haven't seen him play any other characters, so he's going to lock in with the Jhin again.
Mm-hmm. Second game. I expected as much. I feel like we've only seen Jhin out of him for a while now.
And Jhin has the tools needed to win.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
There we go.
Man, I really just, my mind is
that
set on this
very,
fight stick.
Very dominant first game for Arslan Ash. Can CBM turn it around? We'll find out now.
Find out. Multiple walls.
I'm thinking that
in this stage.
It's just a custom thing. But damn, does it look good.
There we go. Nice whiff punish there to start off game number two. CBM to the corner.
Bro, what a low I tell him. The best round yet.
That you've got to start attacking, man. You've been too defensive.
He really
there.
Was, though.
Yeah.
Everybody's asking the same thing. Where can I get it? Where can I get it? Where can I get it? I'm asking the same thing. Where can I get it?
Still has some decent positioning. I was trying to find that down to uppercut.
Wow, just outspaced the demon paw.
Okay, anyway.
Yeah. Using that higher Ashida step, that's also something you've got to be very, very careful about.
Uh-oh. It's not looking good for CBM.
Mm. Oh, smash over the wall, that should be the round. Don't drop the combo.
Yeah.
Cash in.
That's
gonna
it.
Use the rage. Yeah. That's going to be the first round for CBM. And it came from that heat smash wall splat. Man, that heat smash wall splat from
okay.
a mile away.
Cool.
Man, it's crazy. The CBM finally on the board. It's going to calm the nerves a little bit.
He's a post boy, man. He's got to have a good one. It's a solid work. And yeah, you're right. It's definitely got to calm the nerves. Something he needed to do desperately here. As that first game was kind of a blow up.
Yeah. A lot more confidence here from CBM, as we've seen him in that close range, just going away with the post. 2-1-4, really good poke string.
No.
Down two. Okay, goes for the low.
I don't want to watch that.
Goes right under that jab. Arslan.
I'm watching this now. Right now. I'm watching Tekken, bro.
That's such a good punish on that low as
that
well.
That combo.
Chunks of damage on Oki. Look at the patience on both sides right now. No one wants to get hit.
I'm trying to look for good music to... But I'm also... I'm also looking at the small screen that I have on Streamlabs, so I'm not missing anything. Oh my gosh! Wow!
CBM two rounds up, clutching it with that throw to beat the heat.
Pun intended.
Come up though, parry's good.
Down to big whip, nice punish from CBM. 2-1-4. Not much you can do about that string. 4-4-2 now. Demon 4 heat engager.
Good call. Great idea. Look at the backdash from CBM. Perfectly timed, avoiding all these attacks, but no throw break.
Yeah, not thinking about those throw breaks, man. Electric, electric.
Electric.
Plus
yeah, that's a...
Chip damage too. Still has heat available. He's got to use the CBM.
And, you know, you look at that heat dash a second ago. Timer running down now. Found the heat.
Come on,
anyway.
Finish it.
Oh my god, one hit away CBM. Can he close it out? Goes for the slide.
Oh my goodness, he goes to the string halfway down.
Yeah, oh, nice.
It.
Nice poke. Poke, poke.
CBM. Answering back with three rounds straight of his own, we're going to another final game.
Final game, okay.
Arslan looked so strong in that first game. Lohai came was like, yo, man, here's how you win. And next thing you know, right back at you. CBM ties it up.
Yeah, really good adaptation. Arslan Ash, he's really getting into that water, man.
I mean, pressure's on. I mean, this is his moment, right?
Ooh, okay. We've got the descent into subconscious. Now, we've seen quite a few times when Arslan's been using that down back three. CBM going with that 30 frame while standing punish. That breaks
right.
the floor.
Ash to sticking with Nina.
Too many lows here. If you're Arslan Ash now, Jhin pretty good on the stage. But here we go. Final game, top six qualifier.
Yeah, this is a big one. CBM, Arslan Ash, Korea versus Pakistan again.
You see it every tournament. It's insane. Who is going to take it though? Good pressure right now from CBM.
Man, the demon pause.
Yeah, I don't know why he was playing so defensive in that first game.
Trading,
again,
trading, trading.
Not being broken, Rip.
Yeah, it's pretty unusual, right?
Try to.
Go to the tidal
yeah,
wave.
Yay! Oh, ooh!
A throw that breaks the floor.
Almost hit a tidal wave.
There it is.
Boom,
oh,
boom.
One hit. He should break this one, though. Hard floor break.
Nice!
Oh, okay.
Put the button. We're going down. We are.
Okay, interesting choice.
Down we go.
Downstairs.
Pop
There's
up.
Another floor break here. Potential. Is he going to hit the heat vest? Yes, he does. To the wall.
Wow, good combo.
Whoa. Oh, I know what you were trying to do. Boom.
Try to go
nice.
For slide and CBM
nice, nice, nice.
Takes the lead. That's four
Great.
Rounds straight here versus Arslan.
Yeah, Arslan, take a deep breath right there. Pressure might be getting to him right now.
Mm-hmm.
And you know CBM's looking. He wants a floor break.
Yeah, definitely wants it. Arslan, got to be careful using that low, man. One block, and it's gonna be.
Don't look at my shit.
Board four, big whiff, no punish.
Locked down for 1-2.
Get off me. Get off me.
Both guys with crazy defense right now. Down to good timing. Catches Arslan, but the launcher coming in there with the sidestep two should get the wall hit with the right combo.
Combo's gonna activate heat as well with it.
Yikes.
Going downstairs. Allow CBM to use it. Gonna take up a chunk of recoverable health as well.
Nope.
Oh, we got strings.
Oh!
Engage. Nice. Give me that health back.
What are you doing?
Just for the pressure. Nice.
That's a round.
Wow. Okay. Good stuff for Arslan. Again, another situation where we're one round apiece, one game apiece, all even.
Back and forth here. Bottom of the stage here. Back and forth, poke for poke right now, two throw, broken.
Okay, good block on that damage, but not the best punish. Goes to the throw, good break.
CBM is sharp in the throw breaks right now, not that one.
He can't escape from there.
The down two, rage available, just poking away. Arslan has a very healthy life lead.
Get off me!
No for CBM. Wrong punish again.
Finishing some strength, and ooh, just like that, it's set point for Arslan Ash.
It's Arslan gonna make another top six winners and Evo. He starts off quite strong on this round. Goes to the low, no block.
Oh my god, big lead. CBM's in trouble right now. He's being really defensive again and starts them with this sidestep into the launch.
That might be it.
Is this gonna be it? I don't think so.
That might
be it.
He dashed.
Oh,
yeah.
Arslan Ash, winner side and top six for Evo 2024.
It's all right.
Man, he does it again. He's done it again, Arslan Ash. Not a massive pop off there.
I mean, no, honestly, it's Ash.
Yeah.
So
you've been there before, man.
Yeah, you know you're gonna get
losers and making it into tomorrow.
You're gonna get top quality.
And Arslan, you know, making it in tomorrow.
All right, I'm gonna get some water.
So
fuck it.
Crazy.
I'll be back.
So crazy. Four Evo titles, and he's back on the winner side of the bracket through 4,646 people still on the winner side of the bracket. Come on, man.
It's like, you know, you look at the bracket and you see someone like Arslan, these guys, you're like, there's no way he could do it again, right? Because there's so many strong players. Surely someone will beat him, right? But
this is
he's
crazy.
So locked in. And again, I think it really does come down to the training these guys have, you know. We've now both been to Pakistan. I've been multiple times. I see the way these guys train. It is day in, day out. Offline training with the best players in the world, you know. And it's just, it's insane, man. But talking about insane, our next game is also going to be pretty insane, Rip.
Lohai returning to the States to go up against Rive. This should be fun. Shaheen, yes. Maybe?
Shaheen, Dragunov, I don't know, but I mean, Rive going to be rocking the gym. Saudi Arabia versus Korea. We haven't got a Korean in the top six winner side yet, but oh this God. Is an opportunity here. Raif, I mean, rocking that gin. Really, I've been watching his matches that have been taking place off stream, and he has just been steamrolling everybody. But to steamroll someone like Lohai, it's pretty hard to do. It's going to be difficult, but I mean, he's had some close calls already.
Yeah, without a doubt, man. I mean, it hasn't been an easy path for any of the players here, right? But these have all been close matches. This is such a struggle, and now all these players, all these last two players here on the winner's side, one step away from getting into that top six. Pressure's got to be on Rock, man. He's so impressive to me. Didn't he only start playing in like the second half of Tekken 7 or something?
Yeah, season 2 of Tekken 7, he started playing the game. Had some pretty good wins in the official Tekken online challenge stuff, you know, when they were doing that back during COVID. But, you know, once he started traveling again, after the pandemic, I mean, just winning, man, coming over. And I remember when he started traveling internationally for the first time, came to Europe quite a few times and didn't have good performances, although we knew in casuals how strong he was. Mm-hmm. And it's like, once again, you have to travel, you have to be on the stage in order to get over those nerves and learn how to play, right?
Oh, of course, yeah, without a doubt. Same thing we talked about earlier with
Edge. Yeah. All right, it's gonna be Steve coming out from Lohai. We're starting off on the Ortiz farm. Here we go, our final top six qualifier on the winner's side. Saudi Arabia versus Korea, Raif versus Lohai.
This is wild, and it's gonna be Steve Fox for Lohai to try to qualify.
Yes.
That is crazy.
This is one of his main characters, man. Let's see what he can do with it.
I know gym players have always complained about Steve Fox.
Yeah, it was one of the picks that we always saw Nii go to whenever he had played against a Jin player. And it's because Jin doesn't have the best kind of high-crushing tools. He does have down two now,
like that, great.
But yeah, down four, down two, as we're seeing early on from Riot, can go under those big counter-hit moves.
Yeah, that counter-down push doesn't get much more as it used to in seven either. So this matchup should be closer, you know, on paper at least.
Yeah, for sure. Over here.
Over here.
Punish it. Good.
Why do you not sound like Steve? Aren't you from his place, dude?
But I didn't sound like Steve.
No, he sounded completely different.
Over it. That's what he says.
Okay. Over here. Come
no,
on.
No, no H. Just over here.
Over here.
Yeah.
I'm getting good.
All right. Big damage. Look at this from low high. Hey, no fan. Rage available. Low high. Looking so good. Looking to punish. Okay. Right. Panicking a little bit. Low high. Looking so strong.
Shit. That was a really weird heat burst.
Okay, yeah, I'm back.
With the cancel. Low parry, double rod.
Yep, good start to the round here. What's he going to do for the combo? Tries to go for the wall carry.
Got him again. Man, he's countered down 4-2s.
Okay, 2-1, 2-1. He's locking him in the corner there, low high, but he managed to get out.
So patient, right? Defensively, stepping away, blocking all his things along the way to get away from that wall, but Rive keeping him there.
Yeah, I think low high understands he only needs that one counter hit, but Rive...
Oh, no, you got another gen.
And this is going to be some nice damage and should get the wall as well.
Sir. Bang, boom. No, sir.
Too many hits.
Yeah, the down bad. We didn't connect either. Rive interrupted it.
Oh, he gets the duck, but no launch.
Don't look at me.
Uh-oh. God break.
Mix time. Rocket launcher.
Activates heat. Down four to go under the high. Mix up time.
Dash.
Oh,
the rage. I'm going to kill him.
Oh, my God. He's dead.
He's dead.
He's going to be dead. The less health you have, the more the rage art does. And I think that's going to be dead. Max damage. Yes.
Wow.
So high rage art.
The classic.
Was that three rounds straight because of that rage art? I think it was.
It was. And now Knee coming up and Joker coming up to Rive.
Oh, here
we go.
Wild, dude.
Low high. Is he going to be able to do it for Team Korea? Getting into winner's side. And remember, that's our 2018 EVO champion. It was with the Shaheen back then. And then we see Rive and Joker. These guys have been traveling all around the world together. They're training partners. They're always coaching each other as well.
Contact lens fucked me over.
Think about it, too.
Okay, I'm here.
Low high came up to coach CBM during the Arslan match.
Yeah.
And now, if he wins this, he probably is playing Arslan. So it's like he was prepared like before he's even going to be prepared for it.
For sure. We're going to space. Here we go. Potential final game now, if Loai can take it. Right. Can you bring it back?
Oh, my God. My fucking eye, bro.
He's falling short right now. See, Rob can turn it around. Look at that 4-4. Doesn't find him a nice duck in the high.
Yeah, he's been ducking his highs, but not getting the launch of the wall side to choose what he needs to go for.
Gotta believe it's almost like the pressure is finally getting to place now that the top six is so close.
Yeah, I mean, low high, no one's done this to Rive. This
I think I'm
yet.
All right. No, I'm
so
not. Fuck me.
All its reads, but low high playing so solid. And we saw Rive versus Knee before a dream hack when he was able to bring it back, even after losing so convincingly.
I just missed the round because of my fucking contact lens, but whatever.
Great adaptation. Here we go. Wins the first round of game two.
Go to the mid. Counter throw. Okay, no break there from Rive.
Harder to break, obviously.
Good, catches the sidestep. Here we go, pushing him to the wall now. Both guys with heat available. Mid, good punish.
He's so close.
Yeah, he's keeping it a lot more tight now with the post. Right.
Damn, he didn't do anything.
Oh, big whiff, no punish.
Close.
Nice. Okay, Rive now two rounds up.
Oh boy, pressure's on.
He does this so often. The floor is lava now. Floor blast available.
That's who gets to use it.
I'm still watching.
Counter it. Magic Force. Just takes the down four.
I might just take off my contact
lens. Oh,
going
as well.
It's annoying as shit.
Oh, brother. We're going down. We're going up.
And we're coming back down. Here we go. Dive. Oh, the legend kick. Rive with a massive life lead. How has he turned it around?
This is wild, dude. All the match has been a rocket launcher. Give me back that gray. Dude, why just challenge the heat engage?
Yeah, Rive not afraid here. Here we go. Slash kick. Activates heat.
Counter it. Get over here. Yes, doesn't guess right.
Wow, look at this though from low height.
If low height, no way.
The house sweep. And the back.
Got him.
One. A pop up there from Rive. He says to Joker, I'm okay.
Did he already say, come up? I don't know. I don't know what it was, but yeah, shaking it out.
No, yeah, he's coming up. Both coaches coming back up. Look at the scenes right now here. EVO 2024, Knee and Joker, the coaches. Low high Rive, Rip, this is crazy.
It's so tense here, man. I mean, I really feel like the pressure is getting to these players here. That first game from Rive, the first game from CBM, everyone's just not playing their usual self, and they kind of had to warm up into the set. Tied up now, one apiece, final game situation. Low high has been sticking to the characters. He hasn't been switching characters mid-set. We'll see what he decides to do here, but I think it's probably going to stick to Steve Fox.
Yeah, I mean, look, this is high-level stuff, man, because, Rip, how many times have we seen already in these top six qualifiers the first game being so one-sided and then just bringing it back? These adaptations are being made. It's insane, but we're finishing this one off in the arena. Saudi versus Korea. Rye versus Lohai. Who is making it for our last spot in the winner's side top six?
Absolutely bananas, the 2-1.
Starting off quite aggressive, and that's what happens when you're too aggressive. Down 4-2 count it.
They gotta be careful with aggression, especially against D-Fox.
Oh, he's got him in the wall.
They're looking good, but look, Lohai still keeping it even. Both players still have that access to their heat bar too.
He wants that back four. Okay, trying to go for the parry. A nice throw there. That is a punish.
Oh, my God, dude.
Oh, he went for the mid.
Oh, boy. That's going to cost Ryan first round. It looks like it's going to go to Lohai just to finish that, and he does.
Yeah, finishing it with the heat smash. Just keeping it very, very simple. Lohai strikes first blood.
Round two. Oh, my goodness. He's crazy. What kind of a crazy start was that?
Yeah, I mean, he tried to go for it, man, but Lohai wasn't ready.
No, he wasn't. He's like, he totally caught off guard.
Lohai now. Guys just going blow for blow.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to catch that count here with 1-2-4. Lohai though, winning in these exchanges, has the life lead, and get there's a low parry.
Yeah, Lohai, solid defense right now. Combo, activate heat to the wall.
Can he kill here? Oh!
Dash!
Oh, the Versace.
Not enough, tiny pixel. Ryve has a chance. Not gonna get it. Went for the high. Lohai just did set point for Lohai.
Lohai,
okay.
Here we go.
Fuck, dude. I
for top
hate
six
this.
Winner's side here at Evo 2024.
Contact sucks sometimes.
A former Evo champion. Good block on the down four.
Lots of trouble. Fixing the scraper. Back one, not a counter hit.
Good. Okay, here we go. Once again, Lohai with a nice life lead. Ryve having trouble opening up this defense. Go though, steals it back. Needs a reverse sweep now. Both guys still have heat available. When are they gonna pop it?
Gotta be soon.
Yeah.
Oh, you read that.
Good reactions there from Lohai. Last second low parry. Versace. Oh boy. Okay, the back 2-1.
Ryve still alive, man. We've seen it time and time again. Can he stay alive? Oh, Lohai close it out here.
He confirmed that with the Zen stance. Over it.
Yeah.
Over here. Down four. Are we going to go to another final round? This is absolutely insane. He's got Lohai in the back.
Oh boy, the big delay on the wild end. 1-2 wild man combo.
Utilizing that Zen starts now just to try and be quite evasive. Activates the heat now. Wants to keep Lohai to the wall.
Good challenge with the 1-2-1. Lohai's got a small life bar lead. Ryve, heat timer running down now.
The jabs, the jabs. Finishes the string. Blade the scraper. There is the heat smash.
Pressure at the wall now. Nice block.
Man.
Not going to get the right punish.
That was meant to be a throw break.
Of course it was.
Still has heat available and rage Lohai. Oh,
good block.
What
wow.
A reaction.
Oh, Lohai is right there. He's about to make top six.
Oh,
he's
my God.
Final round.
Once
Ryve.
Again. I can't Lohai. Believe this. Who's going to take it?
Who's
his name? Reef? Rafe? Rafe?
2-1.
Oh, boy. This is absolutely insane. This is for top six winner's side. Ryve. Lohai's been there before, but he has a life lead now, Hirip.
Half life bar lead. Lohai's got to find his way back in. No gray available.
Trying to find that counter hit, but Ryve being very, very patient.
Double lift.
Lohai's earning it poke by poke. The down two is going to hit. No counter hit, though.
He's so
far, no counter hit.
He needs a counter hit, Rip. He
punish
needs a counter
that.
Hit.
Tidal wave.
Now the mix.
Goes to the mid.
Oh, boy. Ring one back. One counter hit. He's got heat available, too.
He needed that counter hit very, very badly. Now Ryve's back to the wall. Heat available here.
Brrrah.
Oh, my God.
Anyone's game. Who's going to top six? On the back. Another one. It's not right. It's not enough.
He did it done.
Oh, boy.
Crush frames.
That could have been a punish.
One game. Who's
oh
going?
God.
Again, it could have been a punish.
Ryve, you still got heat.
Oh,
God. He fell down. He's back up. Ryve's going to top six of Evo.
Winner's wow, I thought he broke I thought he broke his leg, dude. What the fuck? He got up and he fell right back down. I was like, oh no. Did he break his knee?
Top six. Saudi
right, hang on.
Arabia Dragons Ryve. Oh my God.
That was unbelievable. Ryve there, a madman. And I'm trying to think, did Lohai mess up the combo with the heat jet? Could he have killed in that situation?
I think that what he thought was that he already did, like,
he was in the wrong part of the combo,
yeah, he
right?
He thought that he was maybe going to use the Sonic Fang and get a grounded hit, but it actually sent him
up
into the air. Yeah,
yeah,
so he wasn't ready for that combo in that situation. And
oh
I think,
my
yeah, just
gosh.
in those club situations when you're scrambling that much,
right.
When it's that much stress, sometimes you forget that, you know, you haven't really done your tornado. And yeah.
Exactly. And right after that, it's like his brain got stuck. Like, wait, what is that combo I was supposed to do? And then Ryve kept the offense going, and Lohai never took his turn back.
But amazing awareness from Ryve to be able to stand up and just go for those dive kicks,
dude.
And put on the pressure, and get the health sweep to end there. So
that's
brave.
That's young man gaming right there, bro. He's like, I might die for this. I'm going to go for it. You know? And he did it. Holy. And he's in Evo Top 6 because of it. No Koreans winner side of Evo 2024.
Japan, Pakistan, Saudi Arabia, Keisuke, Atif, Arslan, and Raif.
Wild. Absolutely wild. We got to take a break. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after this.
Wow. Describe the chicken to someone who had never tasted
Chipotle.
It.
Melt in your mouth tender. We don't have a freezer, you know? It's almost like a farmer's market. When you walk into the restaurant, you should hear the sizzle that you're hearing right now. It sends all those waves up to your mouth.
You're making me hungry.
Sunglasses in the day, blue light glasses for the gaming at night. Zenni's got affordable eyewear for everyone. Vibe and style while protecting your eyes. Evo Sunglass, available now.
All right. Wait a minute. What the hell? What the hell? What are they talking about? Excuse me? Killer Instinct? Anniversary edition. Are you kidding me, Max? Where are you?
Red Bull gives you wings.
Fight.
He's not paying attention. Or they probably announced it already. So I'm just late to the party. What the fuck? Anniversary edition? Yeah, what way to release everything again. The same. So I don't even know what the standings are right now. Like, I'm just here for the ride. I don't know if I'll be able to. If actually, no, I think I'll be able to. Grand Finals isn't until tomorrow, so holy shit.
Back to Evo 2024. What's here up? We're in top 24. We've just had some of the most amazing matches that I've ever seen and commentated in my life. Spag, Rip, we've got the winner's side of top six decided now. It is going to be
Poseidon,
Atif, Arslan, and Ryan. Oh, no Koreans there, as you can see on screen. Rip, talk to me.
Wait, what?
This is absolutely wild. I mean, Keisuke's crazy comeback on speaking. One for the book, right?
Winner's semis.
Incredible set.
And then Grand.
You know, with CBM back and forth all the way through, go down to the final
top
game
six
as well.
Bracket.
And then Ryan right now clutching it out against Lowi. Some of the best qualifier matches I've ever seen here at Evo for Tekken, period, across all the Tekken.
And so many of those sets went the same way, where it was like so dominant in the first game and then the comebacks were made. This is high level Tekken, the highest level of Tekken that we can see. And how beautiful is it, right, that we have someone also from Saudi Arabia that made it in there as well, man, because maybe not a region that everyone would be talking about.
UBG, baby.
UBG, man. You know, he made it in there for the top six in the winner's side. You know, no Koreans, but when we do have Koreans, it's in the loser's side, though. And, you know, quite a few of them as well trying to make it to this top six.
Yeah, exactly. Let me try to pull up the loser's side real quick on my phone. Yeah! Yeah! Versus Rhythm.
You're talking about that one. Crazy, right?
That's a wild. I think Rhythm, you know, he's been taking out a lot of big names along the way, and, you know, he's able to take out anybody. So even against Novi, I think he's got a shot. Speed Kicks versus JDCR.
Oh, yo, yo.
Lowi versus Ulsan. CBM versus Rangju. So the Koreans are all in each other's path, though. Lowi, Ulsan, CBM, Rangju, the winners play each other.
Right,
and
right.
And they play for one top six spot.
Yeah, and we're just going to be... And that's it. It's just losers now, right? We're just going to be deciding now who's making the top six. But these are actually... Are these top eight qualifiers?
Okay.
These are top six qualifiers.
Hang on.
The next match.
I'm seeing what else they have tonight.
Yeah.
So Nobi Rhythm, winner that makes top eight. Speaking JDCR, the winner that plays, the winner...
Aside from Street Fighter, I don't think there's anything else going on right now. Oh, they're doing Street Fighter.
And, you know, at this point now, when we've got this far...
Mortal Kombat, I think, is...
...talk about specifically about the history and about everything. And there's a lot to talk about. Ladies and gentlemen, This was history. This is history in the making right here at EVO 2024, the biggest Tekken tournament of all time.
I think Third Strike is done too.
Not even close. There is no other tournament that's coming even close.
No.
To having this amount of players.
Somebody's playing Third Strike right now.
Our next matchup is going to be Speed Kicks going up against JDCR. Now, I remember specifically these guys playing in Tekken Tag 2 at final round. I think it was final round.
EGH. What the fuck?
I know Speed Kicks, I mean, this is when he was new to competing, right? And he had a lot of confidence, and you know, this kid. And he was like, look, I can be JDCR. I'll go him. You know, I know what he's all about. Uh-huh. I've got him downloaded. And JDCR, obviously, unbeatable.
Yeah, I don't see.
Kind of just laughed and said, oh, okay, we'll see.
I really wanted to watch Mortal Kombat and react to Mortal Kombat, but.
But it's been a very long time until then, since then. And Speed Kicks have learned a lot. It's a different game. Different situation completely.
Real
here.
Life happens.
You know, back
sometimes and you just can't.
2024 when they played such a long time ago as well.
Just can't control it.
Right now, you know, versus JDCR. I mean, the wild.
I'm talking about work. I was just at work today. Like, nothing big happened.
I think right now I'd give the edge to Speed Kick. However, the loss he just suffered at the hands of KSK a second ago.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's recovered from that because that was a crazy loss. That was. In super dramatic fashion too, the way KSK kept surviving and making those comebacks, right? So let's see if Speed Kick has that goldfish memory and able to forget what just happened,
yeah.
So that he can move forward here in this match with JDCR. I think that's the biggest issue with this match.
You have to have short-term memory when it comes to tournaments, man. And you just got to lock in and just think about this matchup in front of him, man. It's JDCR looking to make it into top six here. There was a time where JDCR was just unbeatable. There was a time when JDCR, you saw him in the tournament bracket and you knew, you know, this guy was probably going to win the tournament, right? Mm-hmm. But it's a different time right now. It's a
completely
Kicks.
Different time. And you got to remember too, when JDCR was doing that, like the competition level, like the international talent that would show up per event was way less. Like he was the total international competition. Like JDCR is saying, we're the international competition here. Now you have like players around the country.
Whoa.
You know, you've got
Pyrang.
Pakistan.
Barring.
Saudi Arabia,
yeah.
You know, you've got Japan.
It's so funny to me that how many times they get Huarang's name wrong.
And it's so much harder for any of these players now because of that.
Yeah, absolutely, man. We're seeing it here. But remember, I was just going to say, remember that we just saw JDCR beating Edge and making him
never mind.
From the Huarang to the
Shiryu. I thought we were going to get a Huarang
for the Nina sighting.
So Nina and Dragunov.
That's one of his main characters, right?
This to me
both
is
really
is
great. What the hell is this waifu shit back here?
I don't know, man.
What the
Let's
fuck
what
is
happens.
That?
Let's go, Speed Kicks.
Okay. Here we
okay,
go.
Okay, anyway.
JDCR, Speed Kicks.
Mama stage.
So this is to make it into top 8.
Where is it now, Paka?
Yeah, you said that really confusing because no one cares about top 8 at Evo. Yeah, it's only about top 6, but yeah.
Llama. Fuck off.
Like 7th at Evo now is like, whatever, bro. You're going to make top 6.
That's
you know?
It.
You don't get to play in the arena.
How long have I been on? Not even an hour.
Okay. Yeah, a little bit slower pace, right? Compared to the
I know nothing about Dragon Oven and yeah, nothing about Nia.
We're not gonna get anything that fast paced until tomorrow, man.
What the fuck?
Yep. Kind of just poke away, but JDCR looking super.
Animals are going crazy in the background.
We're gonna spend it for the plus frames.
I think maybe it might be an alpaca.
Yep. Go to the rock before and okay, speakers. Did go for the Twitch duck there, but JDCR's time on the down two really solid. Gets the first round on the board.
And ooh. I think maybe JDCR, you know, the way his match went with Edge, Speed Kicks, like, you know, I don't
know. Losers won. Top 24.
Yeah, that's what I think happened here, yeah. He's probably like, you know, maybe just try the Nina out here. Might be too risky.
So is this the start of Losers then?
There's a slight counter here. I think he tried to go for a power crush.
Mm-hmm. Good punish.
Gunshots. Down two again, and JDCR all over Speed Kicks right now.
It's Speed Kicks Nina. You know, I mean, he's a great player. Nothing taken away, but I feel like Huarang is his main, bro. It's been there for so long for him. And at this level, like, you're trying to get into top 8 side of EVO, 24, biggest bracket ever. Like, I feel like he's his main.
That's it, man. Yeah,
Third Strike is going on right now.
Familiar with the character and all the situation, but he's looking good with the Nina in this round, though.
Let's take a look at Third Strike.
Trying to get this reverse sweep. Big chip damage, crazy chip damage.
We can find it.
Hey. Bottom balcony here, too. Got the pressure for it, doesn't need the break.
Or, no, wait, never mind.
Right now, JDCR on the back foot, but he has heat available.
Never mind.
Oh, boy.
Right? No.
Oh, big whiff. Small punish. Try to go for the heat smash. Down jab. Oh, nice.
Block. There it is. Necessary. You know, JDCR were surviving just by blocking a couple and getting a couple punishes there.
What am I?
Yeah, you can't be too patient. Both these characters deal a lot of chip damage as well.
Mm-hmm. Almost.
He's just looking good, but there's that 1-2-1 heat engager.
Good block.
What a punish as well.
No. Back 4-3 heat dash conversion here for JDCR.
Yeah, this is going to be a long combo all the way to the wall. Big damage.
Oh, what a down 4-2.
That's interrupted.
Wait, what?
Realizing that JDCR was playing aggressive here, but he drops a combo rage available now for JDCR. Whoa!
Sidestep off guard.
He sidestepped the first hit of the heat smash, but got hit by the gunshot. Final round, first game.
Yeah, well, okay, so it's interesting that I missed Marvel vs. Capcom.
It's like he's confused about what just happened. Like, wait, why did I lose
but,
that?
Like, I'm confused. Is third strike going on right now?
Very, very passive hit, and there is that blonde bomb, power crush, heat engager.
Yeah, gotta do
like,
it.
What the fuck?
Not an Ina player if you don't.
Yep. Oh, counter throw.
Life bar's about even, JDCR. Timer running down, speak expensive first. Trying to lock him down so he can't do it, but there's the heat smash anyway.
That's a big chunk of damage. No one has heat available, but there's rage. Oh.
Not enough health to survive absorbing anything with the rage art either.
Oh, the jabs, JDCR, can he close it out?
Speed kicks in his face now, the rage art attempt from speed kick.
I respect it, but JDCR was not pressing any buttons there. You don't respect that?
No, because he had so little health that I don't think he would have survived even like a 1-2.
Oh, found it.
All right, JDCR, we got fear of
So let's mute this. No, don't do that to me. Don't do that to me, bro.
Jump out, great reactions. MLB has one of the best reactions in the business in third strike.
Terrifying seeing you on the big screen like this because I'm terrified. The meat box is going to happen to me. MLB is still moving on in. He has to find a way out, but he's still dashing into everything. The clap.
Winner semis?
Everything. Look at the
Okay.
Healing.
So,
he's in this game. He's trying to find a way. Healing time off of the sweep.
Winner semis. So, grand final must be tonight then, right? All right, let's keep it here for a while.
Two life bars, if anything.
Nice, grab the kick. Oh, standing liking. That's a great punish. I feel like if he went for throw, Hugo would have been able to tech it. But using a light normal to punish kind of a deep jump in, perfect job. That's an excellent right there.
A lot of dancing in the crowd, as well as dancing on the screen. MLB has been moving so, so much just to avoid threat.
It's the volume.
He's just holding north. The north option is amazing right now.
He's showing some love to the sides too.
It's also because her normals, like jump medium punch, jump heavy punch, these are really long tested normals. Compared to Chun-Li where she doesn't have long air normals. But Elena, when it comes to the air game, more superior than Chun-Li in the air.
Alright, here we go. Up two games, MOV, rocking it out with his secret weapon. He did come up to me a little bit earlier before we went live. He said, you know, I got this. He came up to me, believe in me, I got this.
Oh, the counter pick. The counter pick is working. I mean, he's up two games. Nice, good tech. And look at that tech right there. The side switch tech.
So, so important. MOV gets to control so much of that space and pretty much even, almost even in life with a slight life lead, I should say. Building that meter with that back roundhouse. So active as well. You heard the super jump.
Yep.
I out covered it.
Did you say super thumb? Right, the fuck?
Efficient. He needs to get something. And gets MOB jumping away. Good parry. No, wasn't grounded. I think he tried to red parry that.
I think so as well. He got hit toward the last bit of the spin side.
Yeah, it's a really hard thing to do. It's like a
is this best of three?
Window, depending on how you block.
And it's so much activity again. The jump back normals. Deter Hugo away. Forward throw. Look at that.
Oh my god. Look at the life. It was a perfect. All right. He's not scared. He's like, bro, I have so much life left. Why would I jump? I don't want to give you any reason. Backbreaker, nothing. I will take the SPD.
With so much activity, it's 24 seconds on the clock. Just a little bit under now. One touch away for MOV. Hayao, he cannot make it happen. That is the second attempt in this round that he's gone for the jump down heavy punch.
Yeah,
the body splash.
The body splash. Because, you know, he's trying to get something started. He needs the damage. He wants to use the stamp here. Try to build a stun bar as much as possible. But the thing is, him not having a chance to get the 720 is tough. Maybe even using SA3 might have been a better option. The Hammer
Frenzy, Mountain
right?
Or Hammer Frenzy,
right.
Exactly.
It just might be better in that situation right there.
What the fuck with the heels?
It still counts if she wins like this,
it
right?
It does count to perfect.
Okay.
It stays green.
It does stay green.
Okay, look at this. The back heavy kick. Such a good.
What the hell? Did he hit that?
And it built a chunk too. Oh my god.
So frustrating for Hayao right now. He's not gonna show it. The lariat to hunt him down.
Again, Dan Pierce, that's an overhead right there. But I think MLB is willing to take that because healing is always coming to effect. Again, you gotta get this game.
So it's not a full heal.
Damage.
You can't, do not do the Rhino Horn, no shot.
Oh, look at that jump normal right there. What the pop
off. What's that guy doing?
MLB moving on.
down to win his finals. And he's
this is the big stage.
Issei, a young player. We might see
yeah, this is the big stage.
Back in the future. Obviously, his main character is Chung Li. But the Elena counterpick is actually...
Oh, that's a W? Never mind. I thought that was an H.
She's a character that not a lot of people talk about in this game. You know, kind of like written off in terms of the meta. But as a counterpick, though, MLB, you might be a genius.
Justin. It's been a while just to see the fact what are we doing? What are we doing in a second? Talking.
Yes.
We're talking. We're talking here, too.
And then, who in the heck knows in regards to where they're at, right? That is a really diverse
All right, let's talk about the Street Fighter. In terms of characters, my main has always and forever will be Ryu. With a little Ken on the side. But I'm not closed to learning new characters, you know what I mean?
I love the fact that we have an MOV Elena, not an MOV Chun Li. I love his Chun Li.
Ouch.
But that Elena was inspiring right there.
It's fun.
It really was. In just in case you miss it, let's take a look at the highlight coming in from PlayStation tournaments. Now, this counterpick was everything, but this, I think that moment would have been more for everybody
that.
In the arena. You guys are part of history. You're part of IL.
Dude, did that guy just fall?
Yeah.
This counterpick was.
Look at the guy in the.
I think that moment would have been more.
Look at the guy in the back.
For everybody that. In the arena. You guys are part of history. You're part of.
Oh, he jumped off the stage. It looked like he fell.
Yeah, like
art.
He didn't get too many.
Sorry.
Most of the time he's chasing.
Wait, is this a replay? Okay, never mind.
The best part about his game, he was able to escape the
Okay.
Right?
And then there's still.
Super jump, floaty jump.
Is this still the same people? No, these are new guys. Oh, we got a Jin. We got a Jin. We got a Jin. We have a Jin. Need to bring it back here.
Him in a disadvantaged position and got MLB the whole real state afterwards. That's like, literally, he's thinking so much. He's thinking like a zoner. And the thing is about grapplers, once you crack,
Kay.
You just don't stop.
Yeah, it's just fully on.
We have a Jin.
The entire character,
exactly.
Right? It's a really, really tough thing kind of to realize when you're in the heat of the moment sometimes. But the fact of the matter is you didn't get to see the big, big SPDs, the big SA1s that we were expecting from IL because of the fantastic counterplay positioning, too. From MLB on top of let's be honest, man. Every one of those sweeps, you already knew the healing was coming.
It is.
Good thing it. I have the wrong audio.
Down four here.
Mm-hmm. Here we go.
Man, the jabs of Kuma are so strong. It's a good option to go for. Hey.
Wow.
Hey.
Electric here. Start this combo off. Can he get this wall?
Yeah, he's gonna get the wall. Look at the damage. Oh, uh-huh.
The booty. Well, didn't kill the string.
Oh,
he didn't get it. He tried to block her low parry and he didn't get it.
Yeah, he didn't get it. He was too out of range. I mean, those small bare legs not working in the favor that time.
Oh, CBM.
Okay, that's gonna be big damage. Just counter hit. Has a tornado available as well. Check out the damage with the bears.
Oh, God.
A little bit of damage.
Uh huh. Oh, delayed the string. Okay, caught, dragged you off guard.
Yeah, nice delay here for CBM. Combo conversions looking sharp.
Uh-huh. Down four, down four. Yeah, he's not trying to use any other low, man. He knows Grunchy has the reactions. There we go. Chip damage time. Chip damage time.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
There's a hell sweep down
Bro,
two.
Look at the gray on Ranger right now.
Woo-hoo!
And then just a down four. That's all I needed, right? You blocked the rest of it? Nice.
Yeah, it's crazy.
You blocked half your life bar? Here's a down four to kill you.
Two rounds up now. Floor blast available. Punish it. Ooh, we tried. Down two, counter hit. Are we going to use that full
oh, shit.
Yes, we are with a down two. CBM Wait. In the driver's seat. Goes for that best specific combo.
And man, that hunting bear stand on the floor blast is scary, right? Because the bike grab also does the floor blast.
Yeah, full combo. Wasn't able to use it though. CBM looking for a seven golden lance here. Is he going to get it? One more hit. Oh,
Wait
yes.
a second.
That's stupid.
Side left cannon into the rage yard straight.
Yeah, I like that because, you know, the side wall was there. He didn't know where the wall was. So just
this is
the
a weird
yard,
ass rage.
All that
what the shit is
and
that?
Available as well for the comeback.
Boom.
All right, let's see. That's
it's so weird.
Yeah. Cancel. But I don't know if I cancel yet too far.
Oh, I'm keeping it simple. Jab down forward one. Now he's facing elimination.
Look at CBM. Yeah, I see him looking over.
Yeah.
No water for you, bro? No, you don't need no water? Okay.
Yeah, I think he was thinking, about trolling, you know?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, that was basically a troll right there, the way he looked at him. Puckered his lips and everything.
We're going to Yakushima now, which means the wall's on it in place. So that big damage that Kuma has at the wall is not going to be there. But here we go, second game now. CBM, Ramchu.
Let's see how much batters.
Hey. Oh, man.
Storming. There's a lot of chips as well, safe on block.
Bear X.
Slide you into the booty.
Man.
Okay.
Down 4-4, heat engage, and down 2, look at the reaction there, good punish, and goes for the heat smash, gonna get the round on the board, right?
The fish, brother.
I don't need no walls, bro. Bears are fine everywhere.
Yeah, to be fair, they don't, man. Bears have good damage everywhere.
Can Jin parry the running 1-2?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
It's just not something that you use all too often. Of course, like, it's a lot harder now with those auto block frames gone on the parry. Electrics.
Look at the chip and up, but here's a little hop kick for you, sir.
Yep. No respect there from CBM on Rangchu's advantage. There is the dive kick, goes for the throw, no break from Rangchu.
Okay.
Pretty rare.
Yikes. I see what he's trying to do.
There we go, one more's gonna do it.
Nope.
No,
block
the reaction.
That down back four, he's got it every time, man.
Telling you, man, the reaction is on point.
Kuma's magic four.
Come on, man, stop fucking around. Jesus, to end it.
Now forward one string, CBM on the board here, second game.
Very locked in. Engage.
Yep, straight away in there with the Hayashi engager. Look at the damage already, man.
Woo! Breaking the glass.
Yeah, and that's going to be a round as well. Easy combo.
It's going to be a perfect.
One into the heat.
Wow.
Golden Lens, Rangchu. I feel like so many new sets have gone this way, man. Don't win the first game and then Rangchu. Yep. Try to take it to the final game.
Yikes, he's trying to do an electric.
CBM, you know, he was told a little bit before, but I was a little concerned.
Yeah.
Trade.
There we go. Four. Heat engage down four, chipping away the back one. Heat engage right now from Rangchu. Punish.
Old Bear left to spend the heat smash.
Yeah, get some chip damage there. Still has heat available. Nice hop kick.
Beautiful stuff. CBM still has that heat available here. Will we get a heat dash? We do.
Yeah.
What's the mix up? Goes with CBM. Here we go. Now CBM. One round away from eliminating Rangchu from EVO 2024.
Oh my goodness. This is wild.
Down two, trying to go under those highs. Oh, the pressure in his face right now, Rip.
Yeah, Rangchu forced to take his time here. Screens catching him, Rangchu. Half-life bar gone already. Electric's gonna find its mark.
He's
in trouble.
Yes, he's available as well. This might be the round and the set.
And
yes, you're dead. 4-4-4 for the perfect CBM. Eliminate Rangchu.
Rangchu's tournament run comes to an end here.
I don't want to pick anybody right now, but I don't want to pick anybody right now, but CBM is kind of pulling me to his side right now.
Yeah, I mean, it's wild. That's going to be one of the two Korean players, too. Lohai or Ulsan. I mean, that's not a fun match either way.
Yeah, that's going to be a match where you're probably going to see some buttons being pressed, man. Ulsan and Lohai. And those are guys that used to travel quite a lot together as well. Even, you know, when Ulsan first started traveling.
Wait, hold on.
CBM, Lohai, and Ulsan.
Hang on a second. We'll hold that until
they used to travel
some
together
shit
back
starts.
Yeah, Lohai was always kind of like the one who was on top. And then, like, you know, CBM trying to find his footing in the game. And Ulsan was the new kid, you know.
Has there been anybody...
What?
Are we back?
Put the mic on.
Are we back?
No. Too tired to do it.
That makes a lot of sense too. When you're focused on somebody.
Are we back? Do I look like shit?
Hold on. Let me hold that statement. A lot of damage coming first.
No, we're fine.
Yeah.
Down the street.
Right down many streets.
100 plus weather and the night.
I really love the fact that.
Okay, fine.
Where it's like no risk. After the mix-up,
some water in
I was trying to... Oh god, I'm in the way.
Has been much water in...
Yeah, it's like I'm hanging out with the boys.
That's what it is. Good.
Chun-Li, first blood with the super right here. Lightning legs again.
This is Pee Pee Urian.
That entire sequencing was over.
Hey, don't make me talk to him behind me, bro. What the fuck?
Nice check on the crossing jab. Two frames. Here we go. go.
Violent knee drop to escape the corner. We're going to see the activation here off of the tackle. Ooh. What defensive maneuvers of Tyreek under fire?
Oh, this has to be old.
And he's going to build another meter right here.
Is this not old?
Overhead?
Well, no, it's not old.
Guessed right. Guesses, but can't take the throw.
Boom! Oh no! It didn't kill.
The cancel window is bare minimum there.
You have got to be kidding me. The tenacity to wait.
Okay, they're what the? Execution to back it up. There's still a commercial. Hey, can I get some?
Right, because it moves her box away.
Yep. There we go.
Axe.
First game in Canada right here.
Fuck.
I don't even think they gave me a Melita, bro.
Huh?
No. He's got tacos. Paid for it.
No way, Justin. Okay.
Yeah, this is the slowest Melita maker ever. The taco spot just went down.
Don't cancel there. This is huge. Overhead.
Aegis,
the overhead does
yeah. I ain't walking back. I'm better upset. No Melita chat. Because you wrapped all this up, I'm like, oh yeah, it's in there somewhere.
You motherfuckers, can I get some tacos?
What's the guessing like again?
You guys gonna share? Like what? Mm-hmm. What the fuck? Can I get it?
Nice, good jump out. Look at that.
Please? Back. Right, oh, you fucking hit. He ate my goddamn taco.
Pretty good. Yeah?
Yeah? I don't even know a thing about it, you fucking asshole.
I haven't. It's insane.
Okay, no, we're back.
This Evo.
Shush.
Home without making it to the top six.
And you know, I think you would know better about this, but in Tekken 6, okay. Didn't these guys also play in like some big, big like tournaments?
It's possible. Like, I mean, JDCR has been around forever, but back then he wasn't the player that he became in Tag 2, right?
Right.
So Nobi was always good back then even, right? And he got even better as well, but Tekken 6, Nobi was also pretty darn good.
Hello.
Right, yeah, exactly. But JDCR, you know, super dominant. And as you mentioned, right, the 2015 EVO champion in Tekken 7 versus the 2017 EVO champion in Tekken 7, Nobi versus JDCR for a spot in loser's side, top six, Korea versus Japan. And it's going to be probably another Dragon of Fear, right?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
But quite a few of those.
But this one's going to be a very different play style, right? Atsu versus Nobi was very aggressive on both ends.
Yeah.
JDCR definitely a different defensive style compared
to
Nobi.
Two Dragunovs. Boring.
Is that going to work well for JDCR here?
That's the question.
Like, you know, if Dragunov with the aggression style, that kind of works really well for that kind of play style, right?
But honestly, I think that if Nobi gives the full
honestly, I think I should put it back to Street Fighter, but whatever.
JDCR is going to stop it.
Yeah.
So we'll see what happens here.
Definitely, man. A clash of styles here, ladies and lads. Japan versus Korea. Who's going to make it into top six tomorrow?
Oh, boy. Similar outfits, green and gray, I think. Nice pickup here.
Yep, JDCR in the gray. Nobi rocking the green.
Hey. Good step.
Okay, activates the heat just to seal the turn back. 1-1-3.
Yeah, stuffed his activation, too.
That's frames. Oh, what? This input.
Nice sidewalk to the side.
Oh, and that actually fixes the axis on the combo as well.
Yeah, that was lucky for him.
Yeah, I'm Nobi just... Oh, wow, never mind. Short.
Tried it. Activates heat here. JDCR down two. Gonna catch the sidestep. Whoa, nice.
Back again. He is really good at sidewalking the Dragunov's back.
Yeah, really good stuff.
He knows he's going to turn on his stuff.
Early on, gets the first round on the board.
Man, and now the Wild Fan 4. 1-2-1's gonna heat engage for Nobi. Eight.
Yeah, that big low. Hatchet kick. Nobi with the pressure. JDCR trying to fight out of that wall now. But gets
oh
back
God.
In there.
How did that wall snap from that angle even?
Crazy.
Oh.
The combo though, but still has a massive life.
Damn.
Down four for the win. Nobi kind of running away with this one.
You were saying maybe the style's not going to work out for JDCR. How do you think it's feeling so far?
I mean, yeah, like you said though, you know, he knows what to duck and what to sidestep. So he's get that wall standing too. JDCR with an early combo here, third round.
Big block, big launch here. Nobi Antrimex. Like I have some defense too, bro. But he's dropping his combos.
He's dropping the combos along the line here, man. There's that QCF4. Big heat engager. Pushing JDCR to the wall. There's
engager.
That sidestep rip. Just
engager.
And now we got the wall splat. Get back up on this wall, though.
In the corner, not where you want to be if you're Nobi. JDCR, can he get the round on the board?
He had the step, didn't pull the trigger.
Okay, he smash. Pressure now. Ooh, Rage available, goes for the tackle. No brave face. Dead?
Oh, damn, dead. Three rounds straight for Nobi here. JDCR, oh, he's looking stressed. I mean, who can blame him at this point, right?
Yeah.
He fought through 4,640 other players.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right? And now this is your last chance.
Yeah, that was a big, you know, inhale, exhale there from JDCR.
That's so rare to see from him, right? Like, that's the thing. Like, it's finally getting the pressure of this situation, this moment.
Look at Nobi, man. Zen mode, bro. He's just...
He doesn't look that zen either, bro. He's locked in, but you can see him.
The stress is there. The stress is there for sure, man. But if this has gone like any of the other sets we've been seeing on stream, JDCR should make a comeback, right? But I don't want to curse it. Here we go, second game.
You just did.
No time, but it may not happen here. Let's see what happens.
Again, Nobi starting off so strong, just making his commitments. Good sidestep, but not a big punish.
Yeah, down jabs.
Whoa. Down two counter hit. Mm-hmm.
Got
there we
him.
Go. Good timing there on the back 4-3. Gets the bound. Is it all going to be recoverable health for JDCR as well, as he still has heat available? Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh,
1-2-1. Yeah, I think JDCR might have wanted to use the heat smash there, but Nobi, count it.
Four rounds straight right now?
Yeah.
For Nobi? You gotta wake up, JD. Now's the time.
He can do it, man. But the down, the wall standing two, sorry, after the down two.
Yeah, that's a big challenge. It's kind of a little mix-up game there. Mm. After that down two on hit.
Nobi kind of one step ahead in all these interactions right now. JDCR fighting on the back foot. Nobi just pushing forward. Good duck. You don't see that move duck too often.
That's that defensive playstyle, man.
Yeah. He has to close out the round, though. Nobi's gonna pop me. That a little bit too late.
Yeah, that was unfortunate for JDCR there. Right idea.
I'm about to just take my eyes off.
Time,
my eyes
off.
My contacts out.
Again.
He still has heat available, but I think he's gonna be able to kill with a normal combo. Anyway, there we go. JDCR on the board finally.
Yeah, it on took the... him a minute, but again,
finally.
He required to duck two highs in that round just to get that one round, right? So. Pretty unlikely that Nobi sidewalking to the back, full combo conversion.
Yeah, we've been talking about JDCR's lateral movement, but Nobi's been the one that's been sidestepping JDCR all the way. And look at this big damage. Stage hazards back to the wall.
Oh my gosh.
Oh my
gosh. Not looking good right now for JDCR.
Oh god, where'd it go? There you go. Oh, here.
Dude, cut the pay for that. From the hell? Fountain Blue?
And they're talking.
Or is it Resorts World?
No, you know, if you get like...
Next now.
Is JDCR's run going to end here at EVO 2024?
Oh,
the trade!
They are running too.
And Nobi's just running up into a down two, man. The confidence he's playing with right now.
Wow.
Okay, gets punished. Good break on the 1-2. I still haven't hit heat, and there it is, a heat burst.
This is so crazy, bro. That will be so close to make it into the top six.
This last mix up now, Nobi, the down two. One more hit's gonna do it here. Big whiff, and there it is.
That's
Nobi
it.
With a big pop off. Gonna be making it into
tomorrow.
All right,
I'm taking my
top six on the loser side. JDCR eliminated from the tournament.
Unbelievable. Nobi qualifying here at EVO 2024 into the top six. We're gonna see him tomorrow in the arena.
Insane stuff there, man. I feel like JDCR didn't really get going. And just like we said, it was a clash of styles. It's not going to go like Artif and Nobi did, right? Mm-hmm. It was definitely JDCR being more on the back foot, Nobi pushing forward. But even though Nobi was more aggressive, right? He was a more aggressive player. He was still able to use that kind of defensive style as well in close range. So many times he was able to sidewalk around JDCR and get right to his back. Just really understanding the Dragunov matchup, mirror match, really
exactly.
Well.
And every time he's walking to his back, he gets that string on his back, gets a full launcher, gets a full combo conversion out of it. It's a big deal, right?
Yeah.
And because of that, JDCR is out of the tournament at 7th place here. So he made top 8, which would have been cool like in previous years, but 7th place this year for us.
It's not the placement you want to get, man. Not the placement you want to
exactly.
get.
But Nobi in is pretty tight, right? So Nobi, the original Tekken 7 EVO champ, still alive, still has a chance to become the first Tekken 8 EVO champ, which would be crazy.
But now, ladies and lads, as you can see on stream, it is KDF versus KDF,
dude.
Which means that Ulsan beat Lohi to get to this top six qualified position. I believe this might be our final game, our final set of the day before we have our top six decided. But it's a battle of brothers. It's a battle of teammates.
Damn, it's almost over?
KDF versus KDF.
I thought we were
going to
go
versus CBM.
This is a matchup that's happened multiple times this year already, and I feel like Ulsan's got the edge. How do you feel about that, Spag?
No, 100%. I feel Ulsan has been getting the edge, and I believe they also played in a dojo event pre-Evo here, and Ulsan took it over CBM in the grand finals too. So they played a lot, man. They played a lot, but Ulsan has got the edge, just like you said. But look, there's so much on the line here, man. Stress is on the line. You know, there's top six at Evo for the arena tomorrow, so anything can happen.
No, definitely, man. I mean, this would be the time. If you're CBM, you're like, man, this guy always beats me. If you need to beat him at one time in your moment in your life, this is that moment right now.
Like that.
Yeah. Get into that top six.
Focus.
We're going to see another Dragunov here. Ulsan, Dragunov versus Jhin. Is that going to be it? They got a hug before we start.
CBM does not look like he wants to play. Look at his face. He doesn't look like he wants to play. He's like, oh, I don't want to play this damn Dragunov again, bro. I'm sick and tired of this.
And we see the arcade stick that's being used there by Ulsan when he got that third place
right
in 2023 last year.
Oh, yeah.
Right. But here we go, guys. Our final set of the day has been an incredible day at Tekken. One of the best that I can remember. But it all comes down to this. CBM, Ulsan, let's go.
Starting off with that 2-1 immediately. And now Ulsan chopping his way back in.
Honestly, I'm glad that this is the final set for Tekken today.
He backdashed out, still got
Buzz, we got third strike finals coming up, I think.
Hop kick, CBM.
Yeah, I feel like you got to do that early on. Just let Ulsan know. I'm not going to let you bully me. You know, if you want to go for something, go for the frame traps.
Oh my gosh.
Down for one. Okay, here we go.
CBM. On the side of Ulsan.
Gets the chip damage. Good sidestep into the back. Full launch and CBM with the first round.
Gotta help your mental.
And we've been seeing that last work really well for CBM.
Dragunov's jacket is glitching.
He's been playing it, right? But Ulsan, he's gonna definitely know how to deal with that.
Lock out of range for the punish.
Yeah, gotta go for the wild side. What was due there?
Yeah, the shoulder.
2-1-4.
Look at the range again while he's backdashing.
Obviously, Ulsan grabs that homing move as well. Very aware that CBM wants to go for it. Good punish down the hop kick. And now one mix up for Ulsan. And he goes mid for the back opens two. Have you got one round apiece?
Caught by that mid. A little uncharacteristic there. Back and forth here. Demon Paw engage for CBM. Dash him down four. Chipping away, but there's electric. Catches him moving.
Yeah, I think he's trying to maybe sidestep and press a button there. See if he catches it. Big damage as well. Got Ulsan to the wall, but then he gets out there with the down forward one.
Nice.
Hang off again.
No duck on the string. Tries to sidestep, and look at that again. No respect from CBM.
Good.
Ulsan thinking that it was his turn, but CBM pressing buttons.
This is the time to do that, right? And I've seen this happen multiple times. You know, Evo, like,
what the hell?
In the top eight. Friends who have to play each other in the tournament, they pull out the things that they never do.
Right.
You know, like, I won't challenge you. I never do. Why would I do that? Now it's the time, right?
That's it. You've got to play very unpredictable, right? You're playing against your teammate. You're playing against your training partner. And CBM once again finds himself with a combo. Oh, man, yeah, you can't be using some of those lows against Ulsan. His reactions are on point, guys. We're going to a final round in our first game.
Final round. Game number one. Ulsan CBM down two to start it off. Good blocks right now. Yep. CBM hanging on to this life bar.
Yeah, defense definitely holding up here. Nice sidestep. Oh,
nice.
Dragunov can run away there from the running two.
Yeah, a huge lead now for CBM for game one. Finds the engager as well.
Yeah, caught Ulsan ducking. Oh, yeah, gets a punish. No Wolfman, don't dive kick plus frames. One moment.
I hate that move.
Ulsan's in trouble this game for sure. Just a tiny pixel delays the down for 1-4. And Ulsan's in trouble. CBM one game away.
CBM is one game away from making it to the arena, making it to day number three here. Has he done it before?
Come on, CB.
I don't think he has.
A top six?
I don't think he's made it before.
Ulsan
definitely has. Yeah, Ulsan definitely has. He was there last year. Can he do it again?
Yeah, you can see on Ulsan's face, like, he couldn't believe that he lost the first game. The way he sat back, he's like, oh my gosh, I can't believe now I got to fight like this to win. Here we go, yes. Game number two.
CBM definitely did it at Evo Japan before, but not here, man, I think. But here we go, second game.
Down forward one checks. Vince holding up for Ulsan still.
Yeah, definitely playing a different pace now. Ulsan playing a little bit more reserved, more poking based. Yeah, you can see them once again trying to go for that hop kick. The disrespect. Ulsan completely changed it, but nice size in hop kick.
Okay.
Still got a long road back though. Not much will come
chipping away.
Wow, out of range for the heat first.
No punish.
Oh, it's rough right now.
That's it.
The double sidestep there from Ulsan. Beautiful stuff there. And he's definitely slowed down the pace a little bit. CBM wasn't ready for it.
That's a good start. Oh my goodness. Speaking of stature kicks.
Good. Yeah, okay. Blocking the down two and punish. It is reactable. He's trying to keep out right now with the backboard.
Yikes. How did that connect?
Yeah, that was wild because the backboard didn't connect, right? He's like, I'm going to throw it out full swing for this range.
More pressure here from Ulsan. Goes for the tackle. Did it break?
Boom,
no, he didn't.
Boom,
and
boom,
dead.
Boom. Dead.
Yes, and Ulsan, just like we've seen in so many sets here for the top 24, CBM winning the first game. Ulsan bringing it back two rounds straight.
And Ulsan does this in general, I feel like, too. But CBM, don't give up right now. You can still make this happen. Close it out here so you don't have to play a third game.
Get off me.
Playing a much more defensive style here. Even though he's playing that close range game, not trying to overextend here and get hit by those hop kicks. But nice duck there on the string. CBM going to be able to find the warhead probably.
Yeah, it's a hard wall break. I don't think they've got a break on it yet.
Savage Sword, big damage, man.
CBM, a good lead right now for this round. Spends the heat smash. Pressure at the wall.
Also, still has heat available. He's going to use it and get the bound as well. So going to get a combo.
Earning back some of that gray health.
Yeah, that's a lot of health being earned back, man. Look at that.
Big oh, he had down. It. Man, if CBM was ready with a hop kick or a can-can in that situation, could have been huge.
He's trying to find a count here right now with that down, so we're not going to get it. 12 seconds left on the clock. Oh, the back four string. Is he going to be able to connect
no.
it
with a
kill?
Oh, he got it.
Kill. That is going to kill. The less health you have, the more the Rage Art does. And CBM clutching it out stays alive.
Wow.
This could be the moment that turns around the whole set and puts CBM into that top six. Can he close out this game now? He needs two more rounds. Woo-hoo. Down four is good. With the magic.
Yep, challenging with the Rasani 4. Ulsan now piling on the pressure. He knows he just needs one more round. Trying
no,
to go
sir.
For the can. Perfect punish, but didn't get the wall splat.
Oh man, big lead right now. 2-4. Doesn't get the wall splat either.
What is going on? Here we go. Spends the heat just for the pressure. And back 4-3, ladies and
wow.
lads. We are going to a final game here to decide who is going to be making it into tomorrow's top six. Rip.
Oh my goodness, this is wild. Final game of the evening. Ulsan closed his eyes, took a long blink. They're focusing in.
Woo-hoo, they're both so locked in right now.
You gotta be, man. This is it. One game to determine who goes into Evo top six.
We're going to the Rebel Hangar, guys. It all comes down to this, our final game of the day. Evo 2024, we started with 4,646 players, and we're whittling it down to our top six.
This sidestep electric, that's what you want to see. CBM coming alive.
Yeah, that should go to the corner as well. So this is good positioning for CBM. He has heat available too.
And nice, nice,
yet.
Finish
and he's
it.
He's got
yep.
the combo first round CBM.
Yeah, strikes first blood, man. That's going to definitely ease the nerves a little bit. Ulsan, though, can he bring it back?
CBM's playing sharp, but Ulsan, he's stepping on the gas right now.
Yep.
A lot more jabs, downboard one, Russian assault.
Yeah,
back 4-3.
Trying to find that opening, but also not let CBM press any button. Try to sidestep and go caught by the low.
Okay, no.
Nice
yes.
The launch.
I would have done that too.
There for CBM. The defense holding up. Going to find the wall again, but going downstairs.
Balcony broken. CBM extending the combo.
Oh, that was kind of dumb.
He's got the life early, but Ulsan still has that heat timer ticket. Back 4-3 heat dash.
Yeah, big whiff punish there. CBM overextending. He should be able to get the wall. What was that combo? I don't know if it's dead. I don't know if this is dead.
It might be.
Oh, it
yeah,
is.
Yeah.
Okay,
Dragunov.
That's Dragunov. That's always dead. All right, one round apiece there. Final game.
Oh, my gosh. And yeah, CBM definitely overextended. But okay. Here we go. Demon Paw, Heat Engager.
Down four, catches the sidestep. What can CBM do with his heat?
Again, the big block from CBM, but he's
trying to
combo.
Stick to what you know, brother.
CBM. Did he sidestep the heat burst? He did.
Oh, my gosh.
Ready to go. Dropping it again, though.
Another,
off axis.
Another drop there, CBM.
Big lead, though. Big lead here in round three. Big trade.
Be careful.
Sidewalk is good. He didn't punch. 2-4 is good enough.
Dive
but
kick.
Is it? Is it really
stop
good
using
enough?
That.
No heat available anymore. It's going to have to be an honest comeback here. Dragunov.
Oh, boy. Ulsan
wow.
can do it.
Nice read.
He can make an honest comeback.
No way.
Ulsan trying right. to take the lead.
Back oh my god! The backswing blow! Put it
yes.
in the Ulsan! Over CBM!
Dude, you're so close.
As honest as it comes. A comeback from Ulsan with a backswing blow into the Rage Art. And just like that, it is set point for Ulsan.
Should have done a down back four.
He went for his read and it
for
went
that.
Down for him. CBM, can he take us to a final round?
I don't know.
Or like
man,
a down three or a down four.
He's
I mean,
kind of rough. He had a couple of opportunities, a couple of drop combos last round, and now Ulsan has momentum.
Yeah, Ulsan activating the heat early just to get that early momentum here as well. Has such a huge life lead now. CBM, is this gonna be?
Oh my god!
CBM eliminated it. Ulsan making it into the top six here for EVO 2024. What a performance! Oh, man, he's so happy with it. The stresses.
Wow.
That match for CBM. Okay. Shout out as well. A really good run. But we are going to be seeing Ulsan nice. Once again in the top six at EVO Vegas.
Man, that was absolutely incredible stuff. Ulsan qualifying into the top six, where he will be going up against Nobi, most likely. Which is Nobi the guy who beat him and sent him down to the loser bracket?
Yeah, it was, yeah.
And now maybe they're running back in the top six. That's wild.
This is insane. Man, that was our final game of the day. And I just got to
final
say,
game? Okay. So, all right. So it's time for a little Street Fighter action now. What is this, loser's quarter? What's going on?
Uh-oh, Kyle's close to that bar. Because it's like, I feel like it's a mental thing. You're thinking about, how do I avoid SA1?
Right? Sometimes the best defense
what?
Is a great offense, but we do get the backbreaker. Hayao on the offensive because he has Super Art 1 on deck. Frankie, what are you going to do about it? Checking him on the other side.
Okay. Giga's Breaker is coming. I think he tried there. He just missed it. It would have hit, though, if it came out.
Oh, man.
Oh, you got to
watch
out. Change it.
Oh, wait,
so Tekken is done for the day.
All right. Oh, my God. Okay, go for the throw. Nice. Back
now we got
up.
Some third strike
He's
action.
Not dead yet. Do we go for the cross up top two?
He goes for the universal overhead, then backs away. Dashes up in danger. Chip.
Oh my god, no! No! No!
Jeez! Okay. That parry!
Oh! Oh my god! Oh my god!
How did he do that?
He went past the SA3! He went for the roundhouse! He jumped over completely!
Wow.
That is a worthless button! That button is so worthless! But he was able to make it useful! In a very
is this touch, old though?
Crazy scenario. And look at this, the pop up. This is what he wants. He is a showman. But Jesus Christ, what a freaking play. Third what strike, everybody.
Happened? What just happened? In
oh
your lifetime of
God.
Playing this game, we've seen once in
oh
the air,
my
we've
God.
Seen the air parries, but once that punish happened, did anybody expect that roundhouse from Hugo
no.
to go over a wake up
SA3
Jinrai.
Oh my god. But it's the fact that he had literally thinking so much of the future. Thinking so much of the future of just like hitting that standing heavy kick. The like I said, it's a worthless button.
That's crazy.
It's a worthless button. And he made it work.
This guy.
I just thought
that
okay,
button has no friends.
I literally thought SA3.
Okay, sorry, I'm
okay,
just
we are
trying.
Now all of Roundhouse's
we're,
friends.
Yeah, we're going on to game number five. But everybody, please. We know we just saw probably one of the best plays in fighting game history, especially for Third Strike. Give it up for Frankie from New York City, man. Hitting that top six. Coming in here. You know what I mean? With a broken leg. You feel me? Playing some Third Strike. He played amazing, representing New York City, representing Jazzy Circuit. So
Check.
Big shout out to him. But I need to see it again. Can we please go to the PlayStation Tournament replay? That was beautiful. Oh my god, I can't believe how good that was.
I pray to God that they have just that alone as a replay, Justin.
You have to.
You. It's an absolute must.
It was the final like decision to win the game.
I also wouldn't be mad if the replay highlighted the splits. That was actually kind of impressive.
The crowd interaction. I mean, he won the crowd.
Bro, how
he
do you
won
do,
the crowd
how
at this
do you
point.
Do that at like plus 40? How are you this good
he
at
He said plus 40.
How are you this good at third strike and also this limber, man?
I mean, if you,
you have your priorities straight.
If you follow his social media, he literally will post like a random character move of the day, like a Buster Wolf or like a spinning bird kick,
sure.
And he will literally do the animation in the pose. It's just insane.
Justin lose weight?
We'll see him learn
was that just the camera? No, I think he lost weight.
Yes. In the meantime, let's take a look at the replay once more. Oh my god.
This guy got Kyrie Irving on his shirt.
He's tricking you. He's like, we're friends, right?
Yeah, we are friends.
Come on.
Cameras, I've seen this all the time when it comes to selfies. Most of the time, the person taking the selfie takes away all the skill of the opposition.
1,000, because you're like, oh,
come
yeah,
on.
Cool. It's casual. Mm-hmm. My god, that was... How many 720s did he land? Like four or five? In a first of three?
I think so. That is just something you could expect. Hayao and 720s just go together.
Yeah, it really is. Like, we, you know, I don't know how many times I have to say.
Yeah, that freeze frame.
He literally, I don't think there's any other player
Come
that
on.
Can be better than him at landing 720s. Currently, right now, the way he lands it, it's just so interesting. Because he's thinking about every scenario. Like cross-up jump, forward jump, neutral jump, air parry. Ugh! To the ground with the elbow, too?
Dude, my kneecap busted when he hit the floor. I'm not going to lie to you. Oh, my God. Just look at that, man. You have to have such mental fortitude to, one, keep track of the person in the way that he did, but also the execution to get it on time. Look at this right here, ladies
look
and gentlemen.
At this.
Absolutely
oh
insane.
My God.
And then this is the moment. How does that happen? Tell me.
No, he laughs. He's like, oh, I can't believe that worked. That's what. That's the expression he had, bro.
He immediately jumped to the crowd as well.
He is always so happy. I just love the fact that this is him. Like, even earlier when we were just commentating,
sorry,
earlier,
I'm trying
we
to
waved and we
put
waved
some
back.
Volume
right?
Yeah,
on
so that was
thing.
It was kind of weird because we were behind the
volume
scenes,
on this channel
right? During
is really
the commentary for pools.
Even though
he was waving
like, I got
the
shit high
as
shit.
Front crowd, they all but, went up whatever. To give him a high five and everything. Like, he's a person that can just
win
just with his charisma and his just exciting gameplay. And the fact that, like,
Hugo
in a third strike, top six. Evolution 2024, Las Vegas. I would never expect Hugo being here.
Truly.
So the fact that he's here, it's just making the game even more exciting as usual because it's a character that you normally don't see. And most of these guys here, literally in the crowd, first time watching Third Strike, they might have became a Third Strike lover after that.
If not, I mean, I'm sure they're going to be a Hayao and Frankie fan no matter what.
Yeah,
because
right?
That's got to be like one for the ages, one for the books, right?
Oh my God. I was screaming. I almost lost my voice for that.
We definitely have to recover, 100%. In the meantime, again, we got to take a short break. When we return, we'll have one step closer to our conclusion here for Third Strike at EVO 2024. Stay tuned.
Yeah, Danny. All right, more Chipotle.
Yeah, the cows are hand-mashed, the chips are hand-tossed, and everything is made fresh.
You make it fresh every day?
Yes, every day. The Chipotle way is we make it fresh every day.
Sounds delicious.
Dude, why'd you put your new rig in the basement?
Didn't you hear? Feels like a gillionaire now.
Basically, my new connection is so strong I can game anywhere. Check it out. We've got Gamer Rocker, Gamer Floaty, Gamer Couch.
Wow.
It's got wait, wheels. Was that
gamer
actually
bench,
the end of Tekken?
Gamer Throne. And Gamer Mower.
Guess what we got?
It's hard to game while walking downstairs.
I get it.
That's smart.
Live like a Degillionaire with low latency everywhere. Hey. AT&T Fiber with Wi-Fi.
Do you want OK FGC merchandise by OK FGC artists? Well, you're in the wrong ad if so, because here at 10-0, all we got's the best FGC merchandise
yeah,
by the best
that?
FGC artists. Just look at all this great merch. You can make this your whole wardrobe. I should know. I have. Our 10-0 merch booth will be open all 3 days at EVO 2024. If you're not here in person, visit us online at merch.10-0.gg. Stuff this cool won't be around for long.
Okay, so with the way that I'm guessing, oh my God. Whatever. So with the way I'm guessing how this works, one of these four up here, this guy wins, he moves over here, and this guy loses, he moves over here. If this guy wins, he goes over here, and this guy loses, he goes over there. That makes more sense now. Now I'm understanding. I'm understanding. All right, Tekken is done. So
versus Rock Lee, Naruto. Don't turn your head. I saw what you just did there.
Let's get rid of that. Blow this shit up. All right. Okay.
Oh, yes.
The fuck, they got sneakers? Sneakers! I want those Nikes, bro. I want those Tekken 8 Nikes. No, I don't want the Nikes. I want the fight stick, bro. I want that Tekken 8 fight stick. Nike cross Tekken 8 fight stick. I want it. I want it. Am I here? Am I here? Oh, am I good? Okay, let's just move volume. Alright, I need to lay down for a second. I'll be right back.
Oh, don't see my feet! What stream? Stuck today, I gotta say.
Welcome back to Evo 2024. How we feeling, everybody? Beautiful, beautiful. Well, we will get back to Third Strike very soon, but we're gonna play a little game. This is the Beat a Champion Rock, Paper, Scissors Edition, brought to you by AT&T. So we have our three challengers stepping up to the plate to challenge our champion, our nine-time Evo champion, Justin Wong, to some good old rock, paper, scissors. Now, Justin, tell me right now, if you had to rank rock, paper, and scissors, what would it be?
Well, obviously, rock is top tier. We can all agree on that. It's the least amount of frames, right? It's a one-frame window when you just do rock, paper, scissors, shoot. But obviously, they have a counterpick. Paper is a five-frame window. When you're just doing it, five frames right there. And obviously, we can think about scissors. It's a two-frame window. So you got to think about your choices, counterpicks available, five matches across the board, I would say.
Wow, that was perfect, actually. Okay, so we have our three challengers here as well. Tell us your name, and I'm curious to know, do you have a strategy for rock, paper, scissors? You don't have to share it because you know, you don't want to lose your edge.
Let him fight.
But do you have one in mind?
I do. I'm Eduardo, and I'll go for the hard reads.
Okay. Let's talk to our second challenger here. What is your name, and are you familiar with rock, paper, scissors? Have you played it a lot, or is it just kind of like, yeah, I played it here or there?
My name is Mel, and yeah, I played it, not a crazy amount, but I'm confident. I was thinking about strategy backstage.
Ooh, I like the confidence. I like the confidence. You got some tough competition ahead of you, Justin. And our third challenger, tell us your name, and have you ever won money playing rock, paper, scissors?
My name's Tommy Chairdeath, and no, I haven't won much of anything.
Well, maybe we can change that today. If you could take down our champion, we will see, because we do have some prizes in store. No pressure. But I think it's time to get the first matchup going. So let's go ahead and pair up. Now remember, it's rock, paper, scissors, shoot. We're going to throw on shoot. Not a second before.
We're doing one game, two out of three, three out of five. You tell me.
This is a one and done, so bring your A game. One and, y'all know me, I love a one and done, all right? It is a one and done. All right, now he's feeling the heat. All right. Y'all can help me too. Ooh, it's sportsmanship. All right, here we go. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! What was that? I saw a pointer. I saw a point. You know what? We'll let you run it back.
Where is the execution at?
Miss input in rock, paper, scissors. You heard it here first. All right. Don't get nervous now. All right. The run back. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Oh, the mind games. GG's. Hey, don't go just yet. Even though you lost, guess what? You're still going home with a PS5. Thanks to AT&T, of course. So, don't feel so bad. Take a look. It's right there. Yeah! All right, congratulations. Let's go ahead and get our second matchup over here. All right. Round number two. Sportsmanship. Are we? Oh.
Right, that's how I know what I'm going to throw. If I shake their hand, I know what they're going to throw.
So he's actually absorbing knowledge. Okay. I see. The mind games are deep. All right, here we go. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
What are they doing?
Ooh, all right, we're going to go again. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Oh! Right, didn't take home the win there, but you're also going home with a PS5 thanks to AT&T. All right, and look at that beautiful box. Our beautiful stage manager making it happen. All right, congratulations. Now our third matchup. Oh, I want to beat it too. All right, quick selfie time. But our third round is upon us. Get loose, shake it off. Oh! He was willing to shake the hand even though he knew that's Justin's strategy. No fear right here. All right, round number three. Let's make it happen. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! Oh my goodness! 3 for 3 for our champion! It doesn't get better than that.
My strategy right there, scissor first, rock second, paper third. We let everyone play.
The variety. All right, well, of course, you know you're going home with a PS5 as well. So we broke the curse. You won something. Let's go. Thank you, AT&T. All right. We went through all three challengers, but we got one more round, and that's going to be against all of you, and even you at home. If you're watching right now on Twitch, you're going to see an extension pop up on your screen in North America, and if you're on mobile, there's going to be a little red button next to your chat where you can join in as well. So we're going to give the people at home an opportunity to lock in their answers. And we're also going to give everyone here a chance to lock in their answers. So get to thinking. Actually, I want to get your opinion. If you like rock, let me hear you. Okay. If you like good old paper, let me hear you. Oh, okay. Wow. Oh, okay, we got some cheers and some boos for paper. Those must be the rock guys. All right, now, what about scissors? I think. Okay. All right, now it's time to go against folks at home. You ready to throw it? All right, ready? Rock, paper, scissors, shoot! Oh! I see a lot of papers getting crushed, but I see the rock boys taking the win. But how the people at home do, I'm curious, because if you won at home, if you chose the right answer, you also have a chance to win some prizes thanks to AT&T. So thank you all so much for joining us. We're going to send Justin back to commentary so that we can watch more Third Strike. Who's excited for more Third Strike? Let me hear you! All right, you know, I don't want to be that guy, but I think we could do better than that. If you want to see more Third Strike, let me hear you! That's what I'm talking about. All right, well, let's go ahead and send it back to the commentator's desk. We're getting back into Third Strike.
So good at Third Strike and also rock, paper, scissors. And he let the entire roster play. That's actually kind of broken. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the fight to the future. Listen up, Justin. I don't know how you do it, but you're one hell of a magician. I don't know how you do it.
Can we talk about how amazing I am in RPS?
We could after. We could definitely do that after. You have to write a memoir, undefeated at RPS.
Bro, you saw I played the mix-up, right? Shake the person's hand, and I let every version. Rock, I let Rock win. I let paper win, and I let scissors win.
You're so used to
that. Tell me that's not genius moves right there.
It's not the first time we've seen it. You've played Marvel.
What?
You've played three characters at a time before.
That's true. You're right. You played Marvel. You played Marvel out here.
But you are pretty good.
Oh, my God. I wanted to win so bad because I know you were going to give me a lot of flack. So I did not want you to trash talk on my RPS skills. But really big shout-outs to, like, AT&T and everything for the PS5 giveaways, RPS. Super fun. Everybody in the chat and also the crowd playing as well, too. That's amazing right there.
I actually lost trying to do so in chat. I will admit, I lost to your scissors.
You lost to me?
I definitely lost to you.
You a paper scrub?
Yeah. You know what? The sad thing is, I was in the arena. I didn't get a PS5.
I didn't get a PS5.
That's how it goes. But I'll tell you what, all jokes aside, it's game time, baby. We have our bracket for the remaining players of Third Strike. Issei versus MOV, that is going to be insane. It just might be the Yun versus Chun. However, we
is
saw that counter
though?
Pick from MOV prior.
Yes, because earlier in the tournament itself, when we were commentating, he fought against Karapump, who was a Yun player as well, picked Elena. So we might not see the classic Yun Chun that everybody loves so much. We might see a better matchup of Yun versus Elena in the best of five. But loser semifinals, Hayo versus Chiriti. Best part is they played so many times, multiple times throughout the same year in tournaments, locals, casuals, just traveling around. So this is a toss-up because I feel like Chiriti is so good at the Hugo matchup when I'm watching him. More aggressive, more reactionary. But you know, before that, we're gonna see the winner's final match. Like I said, MOV. Four-time SKL champion. He hasn't won EVO yet. He said he wants to win. Wow, Issei. He is a EVO 2009 Third Strike team champion. So he already has one
on
his belt.
Face.
He has the trophy because you know why? He carried me. He carried me.
You know, I'd have to check out that replay, but I did happen to see that big W from his stat line. Issei, he's also been a multi-time finalist over at Evolution for Third Strike.
Oh yes, for sure. Like, you know, it's crazy because one of the craziest matches I ever had with him, first time I ever met him was actually in the SPO Last Chance qualifier where me and Ricky Ortiz was able to beat Issei's team. He came into EVO East when that was a thing in 2006,
right.
Double perfected me.
Word.
In Third Strike, double perfected me. You can find the video on YouTube still.
Okay, I'm gonna have to do some homework. This is going to be excellent, though, because, again, a lot of confidence coming in from MOV, from a personal perspective. Again, he came up to me on the side. He's like, don't worry, I got this.
Oh, look
he
at
said,
that!
That's exactly what I was looking for. This is why he was so confident, because of the Elena pick. However, Issei, he's been proven his worth with the Yun. He's been playing at a mile a minute with some of the Genaijins.
I mean, you are not wrong. But think about the Elena pick, though. When Yun is in Genaijin mode, his combos are less effective on Elena because she has a smaller hurtbox compared to Chun-Li. Doesn't get the command grab into standing beam kick. Has to go for a smaller damage combo. Elena, more slippery. Able to... Oh, but that is a punish!
That is huge damage as well. It feels like she falls just the same, but that hurtbox...
No, trust me.
pretty similar in terms of the damage at the ender, by the way.
Also, look at the super. Look at the super. It's not healing this time. Right? Spinning beat dance. Using the level one right there.
Another one. Watch out for the command grab. You already know it might be coming, and you know we spoke too soon. MOV, he might have tried to move out of the way. Those crouching shorts are dangerous. Not only can you link into each other, but you got caught crouching extra damage.
It's really also a guess too, because he's like, oh, command grab is coming, right?
Right.
So a lot of time, it's a 50-50 situation.
Oh, is that why he might have been caught moving?
Again, nice block on the meaty overhead. That would have linked to the super.
Just there it
like,
is.
Oh,
no.
Damn.
Okay. Nice. Big dive kick. Good jump. Activate Genaijin. It's going to be Aeroborn.
Hey, come on. I didn't know if he was going to be close enough for an... Gets caught with the shoulder wrong. It's not going to be too much damage. The big parry, though, this is going to be so significant.
Okay.
Oh, boy. Oh, my God.
Oh, my gosh.
Throw into throw.
Activation. That's huge.
Yeah, command throw would kill right here. Nice.
So would level one bust out. Not too much damage. That was only four hits, Justin.
No, but it's okay because the Genaijin ran out. That's the most important part. If you could spend one super to just take out a whole Genaijin, even the damage nerf, that is a win.
Now.
MOV looking good with 1.5 bar. Oh, wow!
That was a very far uppercut.
Okay. Nice.
And you saw back-to-back throw attempts from MOV. You saw the whiff animation. What a block!
Again, not as fast as Street Fighter 4, but it's definitely safe on block right there. I love MOV's approach, the air approach. The air approach is so good because Yana's an air-based character, while Elena's also an air-based character.
Very interesting.
Sorry.
Oh, I don't know what those up kicks were from the enemy, from Issei. Okay. Definitely an input error, but MOV is going to salvage the rest of this.
Nice.
That was disgusting. How did he end up on the other side, Justin?
You know, that cross up. Look at that. Again with the cross up. Nice. Walk back, crouch, medium punch.
That was so far, though.
The Heracross.
That jump initially from the distance looked so far.
You know, I think it's because her jump in general is more forward. Right, compared to a character like you say Ken, where like the jump is like a bit smaller.
That's what I want to know.
But I think Elena will also with the super jump more floaty. It's kind of like floaty character. Floaty characters actually go farther, right, in terms of horizontal.
You see everything.
It's a really good jump though, especially with jumping medium kick. Jumping medium kick is all purpose air button. Hits the left and right. So I mean, either way, it's a free option for him. The fact that he could hit confirm with a stand light kick, it's an uppercut. You can obviously super cancel with the uppercut into the SA1.
Now. That was a gang of damage as well.
It was.
Especially with Yana.
So this is winner's finals.
Lower health side, yep. Nice.
And then we have loser's finals. And then we have grand finals.
The defense of Yana's not that great. He's close to stun. Nice crouching medium punch. One more hit. Yeah.
Jesus. This is your winner's finals, by the way. Elena is moving and grooving. You ever thought that you would see this in a grand finals?
That's what I'm saying. Are we really might see Elena win EVO for third strike? Okay, nice. Go for the forward throw right there.
Oh, that was a very, very tricky side switch. But MOV absolutely ready for it. You thought you could see it in a palm.
No, no, no. Parry master right here. MOV also a parry master. Also flexible, too, with the, just the movement.
I gotta say, that was a very mad jump jab.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The cha-cha beat, y'all.
The thing about normals in this game, so many normals are just active, and a lot of normals are just still undiscovered. Like, Yun, using medium kick as well, too, can also be a factor.
So?
Okay, target.
I like him committing to the rest of the target combo as well.
He saw the threat of the parry, right?
Exactly that. You say he can't get MOV off of him, man.
If you look at how this match is played, Yun is doing a good job at keeping with Elena in the neutral, but the problem is Elena's pesky normals, crouching medium punch, back heavy kick. Look at the damage when Yun is getting hit. These are chunks of damage just being taken. No combos really needed because Elena's all about just.
I swear, am I late?
Right. A lot of shit late. Understand.
No, the character was so easy.
Jesus.
Look at the guess. Look at
almost dead already.
Nice.
Ooh, right. Yo, you still got that?
Do we have it? Yep. Not too much damage though. Can afford it a little bit.
Hey, 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 right. Hey, 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 hey.
Who blocked that? Who blocked?
Corner, Issei having some life.
Look
at
take
that.
It away from him. Now, that is such a. Now. Just another bar overhead.
Uh-oh.
Four throw again.
Nice. Link's tail. Oh my god. Oh, the trade. I feel like Issei missed the stand jab. If he hit the stand jab, it would have hit into literally Elena was crouching. So that would have been big damage on the activation of the Genaijin.
Activation right at the start, overhead hits once. Mitigating a lot of damage with the defensive MOV forward throw.
Nice.
Does clip him.
Good jump forward.
On the way out, he's chasing him down exactly that.
Again? No, crouching medium kick right there. Doesn't cancel the low, but it's a pesky low right there.
Three target combos already, and Issei is bleeding.
Half-life and 3 meters on MOV side.
Ooh,
oh, we're going to get a combo. Misses
too
it.
Too far?
She's weird. Still, like Street Fighter 4, third strike, she has the same thing.
Yeah, I like that. Just in case the air parry comes out, he
can miss the
other kicks. That could have been it.
That could be it. MOV. Your boy, Master of Vampires, moving on to Grand Finals. He told you, I got this. And look at that. He's one game away from becoming an EVO champion for Third Strike. He's been wanting this for so bad. Ever since the first time he came to USA in 2005.
Shit, what the hell
happened? Always has been wanting to win right. You know, anyone. is ready for the counterpick. Anyone is ready for the counterpick.
Neither of us.
Pretty might be the only one to force him in the Chun-Li mirror match. That's the only option, because right now, if Hugo makes it to the grand finals, we're going to see Elena. If Yun makes it to the grand finals, we're going to see Elena. If Chun-Li makes it to the grand finals, Chun-Li destroys Elena.
You know, I just realized who's in the loser's bracket waiting below. So we have to really see if Chun-Li even comes out. But again, Chirithi, very much so, very, very potent and strong competitor with that Chun-Li to be ready for someone like a Hugo. But this is not just any Hugo. So we'll see. We will see. It's going to be a dice roll down on the loser's side.
You hear the crowd already cheering. The crowd is already cheering. Who's on the stage? Look at this. Who do you want? We know. Look at him. He is so excited. He's like, oh, I'm old.
I said, what?
No, no, the way he
immediately afterwards, himself. He's like, I gotta chill for a little bit.
Go here we go.
Some of the great, yeah, I feel that, man.
The back
I'm not even under pressure. I'm not even.
I don't know how it does that, but yeah.
That back problem, brother.
He's strong. You want
the way he's been playing, right? He's literally in this position majority of the time.
He's really playing like that. That's crazy.
The whole time, yeah. I would imagine it would be very painful.
He's allowed to do that too.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. We're going right into
I want to put my
Japan versus Canada.
Oh, we going, this is awesome? Hit him. This is awesome. Look at that. Third strike. Imagine that. 2024.
Lord,
third
strike
in the main arena. Having all these amazing characters. Because when you think about other games, people are really trying to win the money.
True.
But these players, they're playing for the love of the game right now. They want to see who's the best third strike player right now. Who's going to be claimed as the game, as the evil game, him, as the evil champ for spinning right now. Look at you. For some spinning right now. Look at you.
The fuck.
For some third strike. Oh my god.
That's a man. That's a man.
Ooh, evil light sticks?
That's cool.
Let me find out.
That Chun-Li was a man.
I know you guys have all been very, very hyped, very energetic, but this is where it matters the most. One moves on and one goes home. Here we go. Hugo versus Chun-Li. Hayao versus Chirithi.
I'm telling you, I am scared of just Hayao versus Chun-Li. Look at that. Already with the whiff punish. He's just so good at sniping out Chun-Li.
Here we go.
Landing
loser semis
against her is not easy, but he might make it easy. But the
Getting
thing is,
now.
Chirithi got data. They played each other throughout this entire year in multiple tournaments around the world. So this is something that we might see some familiarity. You know what I mean?
In the meantime, we do see Hayao already
maintaining the distance
to the corner with just the presence, right? A couple of hits here and there, hence the light. Oh,
yeah,
no.
Oh my god. Okay.
You thought. Hey, Chirithi does get out of the corner, but at what cost, right?
I know, that's 30%. Misses standing heavy kick. That was a bad one. Go for the parry. Monster Lariat right there. Clap again. Ooh, I love the jump. The neutral jump.
Oh.
Doesn't believe in the hit confirm because it might not be worth it.
You heard the bar fill up as well.
Exactly. Maybe two. Maybe one more fierce, then we might think about a hit confirm such scenario. Oh, oh my god.
Some help.
Oh,
yeah, the clap
again.
The clap.
But even if you parry the clap right there, it's safe on block after parry. So it's a very safe option.
A lot of sense. Hayao's been going to it numerous times over four pressure. Not only that, also in neutral if need be. With the medium punches, yeah, that's going to be coming through to push himself out of the corner little by little. Unless Chun-Li's Fierce has something to say about it.
Yeah, the Fierce is amazing to Chun-Li. But the thing is, if you're going to be Hugo, like I said, you're a master of parrying. So you're going to be going for a lot of guest parrying in the scenarios of parrying standing Fierce or parrying crouching medium kick. Again, forward throw again. Clap.
Oh, midair.
Fierce. Oh okay, my god.
Reset. The sun is.
Oh my god, again?
Boom.
How?
Boom.
How did he not jump? Why did he not react? Like, he's really. Ooh! What is he doing? Oh! Oh! Oh my god!
I am so taken aback right now. Did you see him churn the butter?
No, I didn't see anything.
I didn't see him churn the butter.
Check the stick.
Somebody check the stick.
Check the stick.
How did he do it?
The fact that he called out Chimothy jumping up back and literally following up with automatic jump forward jab. And then this time he sat there and waited because and then reacted with a 720.
Wild. Listen, somebody call automatic. Somebody call Jibbo. Get him on the line right now.
Yeah, we need Jibbo to know. Like, please tell me what the thought process of a Hugo, because he is also a Hugo main.
Unbelievable.
Oh my god,
these are damage. And look at this man, he's playing it out in neutral. Majority of the time, Hayao. Oh! Checking for the fierces as well, you maybe thought.
Hard read, hard read. Jump.
Yeah, that was a hard read.
Nice.
Go forward, does get a connection.
Bah.
All right, what's the mix up? Okay, go for the forward throw right there. Ooh. Nice, good chase down. Okay, good parry from Chirithi. Reactions on point still. Wow!
You better make it count.
That damage is ridiculous.
Something else.
That's right. Run away. Run away.
Oh!
Don't forget about the air throws. Chun-Li has air throws against Hugo. Oh my God.
Dangerous.
Oh my God.
Almost one touch for each.
Don't fall for it, Chirithi. The crowd wants you to do it.
Yeah. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do?
EX.
Oh! Forward heavy kick, crushing the low. Look at him. He's like, oh! He felt that.
Listen, that was an unpredictable exchange, to be fair. I mean, him being two steps ahead, checking the low at that moment.
Yes, I know. That's really tough. Chun-Li also has a really fast dash, too. So, like, just like that. Nice tech on the carry throw.
Truly.
Okay. Yeah, can't punish there. Deep jump in. Nice right there. Not the safe palm. Go for the fireball. A little bit of chip damage right here.
Take all that you can get against the big fella, right?
Yep.
Oh, air. Oh, you got caught midair as well. Look how many dashes he moves on in. And it's so terrifying. Chirithi still having the presence of mind to get the box. That is an excellent rebuttal. Push him all the way to the corner. Yes, sir.
All right.
For the throw at least.
There we go. Yeah, that would have been a cancel with the lightning legs anyway. Cancel lightning legs. That would have been a chip damage kill.
Unless is it best of three?
Down parry
best 3 out of 5?
Or even just block the crouch mute kick and red parry the lightning leg.
Sure.
Even then, scenario where the only thing that Hayao could have done was just wake up 720.
Oh, shit.
Really still a really risky attempt, because most of the time if you see a grappler with a stocked up meter, you run away. You don't go for the meaty, right? But Chirithi went for it.
I think it's fair. Chirithi had a lot of life to sustain that kind of damage regardless. And then, you know, we'll see what would have happened in the meaty situation, or at least in the open situation.
Yeah, maybe later, right? Do you really want to afford 60% though against Hayao? Somebody that likes to make these crazy reads happen.
You already know. Absolutely not.
I know, right?
Absolutely not.
Nice. Using the crouching medium punch, get the pesky lows. What I also like to
do. Oh my
god. Washer? Uh-oh.
Off with a deep body splash, actually nice connected to the crouching medium. That wasn't even a full combo at all.
No, the reset.
Oh, the wall. Variant on top of it.
Uh-oh.
Clap one.
Uh-oh. Oh my god, I think it might happen. He missed it. Look at it. You see, maybe that was the luck. A little down.
The teabag.
Ooh, teabag.
I'm scared.
I'm terrified.
What's he going to do? Chirithi, even he's scared. He didn't even confirm the crouching medium kick right there. You have to go for the air throws. Look for the air throws against Hugo. He has to jump first majority of the time, especially in neutral against Chun-Li.
Look, Hayao is just as scared as Chirithi, right? He's been spending most of his time airborne in contention of maybe the grounded normals, right? Yeah, hey, big confirm. No fireball necessary.
That was huge confirm right there.
Master level from both ends, truly, but Chirithi is the one that's keeping it alive here in game number two, around to the game as well. EX spinning bird kick as a wake-up option against Hayao.
So scary, too.
One of the scarier options on wake-up for Chun-Li, because again, you can't mediate correctly and also pop serious he is in this moment, because Chirithi is not giving him any room to work with, at least for some of these.
Meme kick. Stand fierce right there. Good side switch.
so difficult. Now you're making sure
it's the latest.
Magic happened. She really stuck in this corner.
This is where he's at. Right there. Go to the.
That's what I'm saying.
Pretty no. I cannot believe. Oh, he could equalize it. Actually, he could probably take it away with a single hit confirm.
Oh my God.
No, there's too much life.
No. Is he dead? Yes, he is. Kaio with a miscalculation on the 720. A little bit thirsty there. Just a little bit.
Just a tad. Can you give Chirithi a moment? He will obliterate your life with that SA2.
Nice. The option. Nice. Go for the stand fierce. Uh-oh. Do you hear it?
The chants are coming. The crowd is chanting your name. The crowd is chanting your name. They're trying to give you the enchantment buff, but Chirithi, he is not phased one bit by all the bards in the chat.
Literally the aggression. Oh, the base?
Check it.
One, two.
Clothesline. This game
tied up to go to the fifth game. Nice. Too far.
Still firing away a little bit faster than Hayao.
Sorry.
Oh my God. No.
Annoying.
That's not gonna work.
Oh, that's beautiful. Do you think she really got hit intentionally?
I think. Yeah. I really think Hayao thought too far. He thought she was gonna parry.
Oh boy.
Nice. Go for the crouching medium kick. Chirithi and match point. Hylos at far. Good jump on the Beastmaster. One more shot. What's the guess? Back fierce? The throw! Ohio is eliminated. Chirithi from Canada. Montreal, like I said, traveling around the world.
Wow.
Playing some third strike. Makes it the loser finals. But come on, guys. We know what you guys are cheering for. Let's give it to Ohio for just being so amazing with that Hugo. That Hayao, bro, look at that. Oh my God.
We're gonna see Chirithi represent himself even further in the bracket, getting closer and closer. But one more time, round of applause, give it up, stand up for Hayao, the god of Hugo.
That's just beautiful.
That's a man. That was a man.
I can't believe how many people love grapplers here.
To be honest, man, this is such a genuine moment. This is like a dream come true, a bucket list. To watch this man live and in full effect play the way he plays with Hugo.
I've been
watching this cat since like high school, man.
Literally the first time I was ever
right.
in 2005.
So like, what's next?
Hugo. And the fact that like him and also like other Hugo players like YSB.
Is that the third place match?
It's just beautiful because Dirt Strike is one of those games that gives you the
opportunity. Or is it straight to grand final? If it's a third place match, I'm going to take a break.
Low tier, mid tier, top tier. The expression, of just playing these characters with the act of the mechanics. And it's so different because these mechanics, such as like kind of the way parry works, down parry, forward parry, the way like crouching damage is like 1.25 more, the parry window being in the cooldown period.
Truly.
You don't really see those little things unless you know Dirt Strike, unless one of us calls it out. So the fact that we have this game and you can express the way, we've seen Remy, we've seen Makoto, we've seen Q, we've seen Hugo, we've seen literally Elena in the grand finals right now.
Absolutely,
it's just beautiful. The fact that Thirst Strike can be played at this high level in 2024.
It truly is like a game of expression. In fact, we did see that in the highlights here for PlayStation tournaments. Let's take a look at those exact moments as to when and where these big damage punishes came in, and also some of the expressions IRL from some of our players.
Look at the expression.
Pure.
This is when you know he's serious.
Pure focus coming in from the most charismatic man on the planet, I think.
You saw Chirithi smile. It's like, all right, you got me.
There it
he
is.
He hit with it. You got me. And he knows. He knows this is what he wants to do every single time. But like I said, Chirithi, traveling around the world, been playing since he was 15 in Northeast Championships against me, and he's still here, wanting to play more Third Strike. The fact that he was trying to play Street Fighter 4, Street Fighter 5, and he said, you know what? It just doesn't hit the same like Third Strike. I want to go back to my first love. And that's what he did. And now he's just sitting at Loser Finals with that amazing Chun-Li of his. Oh, look at that. That
Truly
ender
an
right
feat,
there.
Man. And...
the overall sportsmanship, the fact that he was like that ecstatic about like being able to play with Chirith, yeah.
The love of the game. Like, what else can you say? Most of the time, I feel like people are kind of a little salty when they lose and everything. Right? Just like you? No.
That's why I'm a commentator. Justin.
Yeah, me too. But in general, the fact that they were just so happy. They're like genuinely happy. Like, hey, man, you played really good. Yeah. I'm happy that you advanced to the tournament. Even though you beat me, go kill it.
Absolutely.
That's
man.
The best part about it.
That's the energy that we need in our lives. You know what I'm saying? It really is. But for the most part, again, just being able to witness this in this moment for the 25th anniversary is something so, so special, right? But in the meantime, Chirithi, him moving on into the loser's final spot is going to be so, so significant. But before we even get into that,
yes.
Again, we have to recharge our batteries just a little bit. I don't know how flexible Hayao can really, really be, but our vocal cords cannot be as flexible. So we will
yell too much.
It really is. Man, look at this.
Look at that. How can you not
this
get
guy was working
how can you
the crowd.
Not yell for this man?
I'll give him that.
All right. Let's take a quick break. When we return, we'll have the conclusion.
All right. They're taking a quick break. I'm taking a quick break. All right. I'll be right back.
Sunglasses in the day, blue light glasses for the gaming at night. Zenni's got affordable eyewear for everyone. Vibe and style while protecting your eyes. Evo sunglasses, available now.
Wings.
Fight. Fatality.
Look at this merch right here. Evo 2024 merch. I know everyone here has been copping the merch at the Evo store. That line has been filled. But if you're at home, it is now available online. So if you are just loving all the matches, all the games, all the different streams of Evolution 2024, make sure you go to shop.evo.gg and get the Evo merch right now. Get that Las Vegas and get your own and tell people at home that you went to Evo even though you did not go to Evo because ultimately in the end, I know you guys want it. Everyone here got it and it's your turn to get your own. Right?
I mean, pretty good idea, actually. You know what I mean? Pretty good idea. I would probably be doing the same thing. You know, if I wanted to avoid the line, maybe I'd want to like do this little thing, this little shop.evo.gg instead.
Ooh.
But either way, we welcome you guys back for some more Third Strike. In the meantime,
we're back already.
You, in just a moment, we'll be doing a Chipotle free entree giveaway. Whether you're here or watching at home, get your phone ready to text the code to 888-222 because these go fast. All right, text LDB279. I repeat, LDB279. To 888-222 and good luck because these go by quick. I know you guys in the arena absolutely loving the advertising between presented by Chipotle.
Chicken.
If you want to get a free burrito,
there's no medium rare for chicken.
Be sure to do so. Justin's actually doing it right now.
Somebody have a.
Yeah,
I don't know if you guys know.
I'm trying to get it right now.
He's trying to do it. If you want to get a free burrito,
somebody have a bear?
Be sure to do so. Justin's actually doing it right now.
Yeah,
I don't know if you guys know.
I'm trying to get it right now.
He's trying to do it right now.
I want the Chipotle. I text Chipotle score. We got a Chipotle right here.
He got it.
I got a Chipotle.
Beat up.
Shout out to Chipotle. We got a free entree. I got to make sure I cash
222222222222 is exactly where you need to text the code, man. That's actually unbelievable. Nice work, Justin.
I know. Thank you, man.
Let's take a look at the bracket now. Going right into it.
Dang it.
We only have three players remaining, but man, what? Turn to the character. He's going to be chilling in the Losers Finals where he waits his fate against Chi Rithi. But MOV, man, he's been playing spectacular with a character.
Wait, I thought that was Losers Finals.
MOV 3-0 Ohio. MOV 3-0 Issei. And if you're watching this for the first time at home, you're going to be thinking, oh, he won with Chung Li. He 3-0'd with Elena. So now the fact that we have Issei versus Chi Rithi, this is a run back. 3-2 in the winner semifinals. Right, Issei was able to take down Chi Rithi,
really
put him in the
losers right
bracket.
Here.
Are we going to see the
you might
the
hear
same thing?
The win
see the
from
same
my fan.
Of Issei going to grand finals
wait, time to
or
time.
Chi Rithi having
actually,
his own shot to fight against
Chun?
MOV.
Nah, I need to lay down for a bit.
Okay, we'll go for here. Build some beater. Good neutral jump. Got to go for the air-to-air game. That looks like it was plus right there from the crouching. While Chun-Li is blocking low, she has literally more block stun than other characters.
I love the way that Issei got into this momentum. That roundhouse was so far away to knock down Chi Rithi and build himself enough time to get the Gin Agent going without wasting enough follow.
So
anymore, really.
Strong right here. But look at this. Chi Rithi with the standing heavy kick, jump cancel. What a chase down from Issei. Oh, oh my god. Builds a shoulder, but doesn't cancel. We activate their Gin Agent mode.
Man, don't disappoint your brother. I was going to say, Yang looking on, he's like, meh. I've seen this before.
You know what's crazy? If he's getting hit, he shakes his head.
Yeah, but when he wins, he smiles. He puts his head up and smiles. It's kind of crazy. It's a family feud, right? Because Chun-Li is technically the auntie.
Nice eyes, man. That's like really 32-bit right there.
Yeah. Truly is.
Okay, Fierce right there. Go for the unseeable mix-up. Yep. He gets parry on the high.
Jeez.
Gets hit low. Look at the damage right there. Chi Rithi doing good with the Fierce. Yep. Throw punish right there.
The standing light kick? Confirm it to the dash point?
Yeah. More of a commitment. Take the corner.
Yeah, that is true. That's it. Oh, wait.
He doesn't want to activate. He doesn't believe he can kill in the next hit.
Oh,
he wanted maybe one
so
more
close.
Throw, possibly, and then into Gin Agent.
That makes a lot of sense
now,
because
right?
say you don't get to open up Chi Rithi the way you want to, and then you'd have to waste a little bit more meter, you won't get the same damage on it.
That, and if you lose, you go to the third round with no bar.
Oh, that's true.
Nice.
He built so much bar anyway.
That's
right? Let's
true.
Be real.
But Chun-Li with two bars? Nice!
Dangerous! That's actually such a risky thing to try to parry afterwards.
Uh-huh. Go for the end there. Look at the meter. He just got it. Gin Agent!
Super jump canceled, by the way, off of the medium kick up close. Issei gets contested!
No.
But no! Not
Whoa!
What?
Missed the parry!
Nani?
That's Third Strike 101. Is he nervous? It seems like it. Loser finals. Nice block. That was really good block.
Look at this man. Issei, he's fighting for his life. Gets exposed once down below. And Chun-Li, the classic. How many times are you going to see this happen? Low forward into SA to Hoyokusen.
Yeah.
So much damage.
But I think even then, like, if Issei didn't mess up the parry, it might be Issei going up one game right now. The fact that he took that big chunk, because one, he could have done standing kick and activate, and that's just a death of Chun-Li. If you get hit by standing kick activate, it's max damage activation there.
Truly, it truly is.
Go for the lightning legs. Look at the chip damage right there. Nice, low, strong.
Oh, man. A lot of persistence here from Issei. Again, I don't think he has any other choice but to go airborne because those normals just cover up so much space in comparison to Yun's.
The best part about Chiriti's game plan is that he's focusing more, not on stand fierce, but using stand medium punch, stand medium kick, to really catch the airborne dive kick, especially the low one.
Whoa.
I can't believe it.
Oh! And also the fireball, just him running into it. Issei is having the worst luck, I feel like, with his Genjin.
Or Chiriti knows the match. He's kind of figuring out, like, okay, these are Issei habits. I want the run back. I want to show him that I can win the Chun-Li versus Yun match.
Oh, what a delay, too. Did you see that?
Yes.
He opened him up slightly with the crouching medium punch.
Yeah, I know. The crazy part about that, Chiriti tried to press the two-frame jab, right? And it just didn't work, because ultimately in the end, if you have a normal trading with a Genaijin normal, which counts as a super, the super normal will always win.
Oh, that was a missed input for a dive kick.
Yep.
There's no way he wanted to jump short. Like
crouching
that.
Damage.
Jeez.
Look at that chunk right there. Nice. Using the crouching light kick right there. Activate. True block stun.
Command grab, medium kick, side switch, palm.
Okay, look at the damage. Look at the meter building. Half. Go for the cross up. No. Doesn't take the risk. Good hit come from the crouching medium kick. Gonna activate right here.
Oh, that could have been
down.
It.
Yep.
You could activate it perhaps to a stand jab as an anti-air?
Yes, 1,000%. Again, it's so hard. Ooh. To avoid. Does it confirm with the forward heavy punch?
Oh, he's not dead yet.
Nice. What a good read. Crushing the low. One to one.
You can see the smile on Yang's face in the background. Two rounds for Issei. Taking it down against Chiriti now. It's been very, very back and forth, I feel like. Most of the time, Issei is trying to find his opening in the air. That's going to be very, very typical. But the thing is, Chiriti, he's changed up his rhythm in regards to what normal he wants to use to either intercept or
yes.
Get ready for the landing.
He's doing such a great job of this. Just changing the game compared to the winner's finals, like the winner's semis match, right? Like, Chiriti's just doing amazing. But Issei, Superman, activate the Yun, getting hit by the Carif, strong, forward, fierce. Look at the juggle. Misses it, though. You can't see that.
Do you think he dropped it to set himself up even further for the cross-up dive kick, perhaps?
I think more he's a freestyle character, and he's privileged like that.
Okay. Okay. That is fair.
Forward fierce again. That's a knockdown. Forward fierce is really good against Chun-Li until she has super. Chun-Li can punish with super. Oh my god. Look at the damage. Taking out the Genaijin bar. That's huge.
Jesus.
Time for Yun to play the runaway. Build some bar right there. Using the standing heavy kick to catch the jump back right away.
Chiriti has so much life to work with. He can't afford to get some of these heavies. But it's up to Issei to build safely and get the execution. Genaijin, no, not yet. It might be time. There it is. Genaijin.
Ooh, that could have been a cross-up. Usually you could switch sides with that against Chun-Li. Stays in front just in case. Keeping the damage up. Missing the dive kick again.
Again and again. Chiriti having luck on his side for that missed input from Issei.
But even then, the reaction from Chiriti to realize the drop using the standing heavy kick super jump cancel, that was really good too. Oh, the stand medium kick anti-air. Not the best anti-air, but still really good for just kind of like one and done anti-air.
Oh, the forward heavy, so much coverage on that normal.
Nice.
And also builds so much more meter.
Finishes
yourself
the
ready
combo.
For the juggle.
Ooh, good parry. No super though. Here it is.
Yes, sir.
Yep, goes for the reset. Goes for the throw. Standing roundhouse. Lightning list. Look at the chip damage. Activate.
Oh, raw activation.
Ooh, the trade on the fireball. Wow.
Even Issei was taking it back. He's like, ooh, that was sick.
I'm going to be honest. If I was in a situation, I would have jumped back again. I would not have been brave enough to throw a fireball. Because usually, when you think about third strike, fireballs are very weak in this game. Right? The fact that parry's available and there's more recovery on fireballs in general, the fact that Chun-Li Fire was one of the slowest fireballs in the game, was able to take out that clutch moment decision of Gen-Ai-Jin, it really makes every normal, every move in third strike not useless.
It makes it feel like an executive decision from
Chun-Li. It is, right?
To understand, like, the game says to be like, all right, if this hits, this kills, so I have to put it on that.
All right, here we go. Hey. Using the Carol lunge punch right here. Nice, crouching medium kick, spinning bird kick.
Was that punishable, by the way, on hit?
No.
Because I look kind of weird, to be honest with you.
It's definitely, I would say, not frame advantage in her favor.
Yes.
But because it's third strike, we don't really need frame data.
That's fair, that's totally fair. It just looks such an interesting interaction.
You're not wrong on that one. Okay.
Head is blocked successfully. Chirithi trying to minimize the damage. Does so successfully, but man, what an option.
Anti-air
with crouching medium punch up kicks. Very common tactic, but also very difficult sometimes.
And the crazy part, it's so good that he anti-air with that, because even if Chun-Li did parry that, she has to worry about that other second part of the move. Nice, look at the damage right here. Issei looking like he's about to tie it up.
Oh, and a meaty palm, dude. That boosted up his bar so much. Man, what a fast second round from Issei, tying it up, 2-2.
That's a Yun game. You see, look at his Evo badge. He got the Yun Gen-Ai-Jin activation. And the best part about that, he really saved that dive kick, that specific dive kick to the end. Because that was a medium kick dive kick, not a light kick dive kick, not a heavy kick dive kick, a medium one. So that means it goes slower than usual, which it was able to clip Chun-Li's crouching medium kick there. Going to the final game.
Yeah, it's much easier to kind of get a link afterwards too because of that angle. So it makes a lot of sense. Issei in hot pursuit, the forward throw, dive kick just in case.
Okay, standing medium punch. Ooh, nice! Activation well. Station! Shout out to Yipes!
You couldn't ask for a better time to activate. No, but he dropped the sequence.
Yeah, I know. He could have got forward fears, but Chirithi probably was like, thank God right here. Able to go air to air, get the knockdown, standing heavy kick, builds a bar. Nice.
If Chirithi lands SA2, it could be so problematic.
He's not dead yet. He's close.
Fierce. No, reset.
Reset. Misses the lightning legs. The lightning legs would have chipped him out. The crouching strong. Ooh, the cheesy low. Chirithi at match point.
Justin Wong, you called that, by the way. One of the biggest game enders, crouching medium. But look at this. What a game starter.
Hey. Oh, drops it. It's okay, though. Doesn't matter. It's Yun, but Chun-Li advantage right now.
Issei builds himself another bar.
Uh-oh.
The parry. Ooh. Look at the gauge being drained. Chirithi running for his life afterwards.
Forward
throw, slowly building up his bar. What a parry from Issei. Wow. Yes. Oh my God, dude.
No cancel on the standing heavy kick. Uh-oh. Nice. A delayed dive kick once again. Where are we really going? To a final game, final round. Yup, run away.
And what a better way to start the final round here. Issei looking to lock down Chirithi.
Defend! Success! Uh-oh, Chirithi. Two throws. Three throws!
Can we get a fourth?
Oh, caught you jumping! Overhead. Four throws!
One more!
Oh my God, the standing heavy kick did not get the neutral one. Nice activation. Yeah, Chirithi, he's willing to take the command throw. Maybe not, but it's okay. Ooh. Oh my God. Ooh!
He built it again!
He built it!
Command grab could possibly kill. He licked the overhead! Justin, can you believe it? Issei, with a miraculous comeback, licking the overhead and getting the full confirm into the death sequence. Issei eliminating Chirithi and moving on. History repeats itself from the winners' semifinals. Can you believe it?
Do you understand? Do you understand how crazy that was? The fact that he was able to use the Gen-Ai-Jin bar, and right, literally, he hit at the probably where there's 2.5 seconds left of Gen-Ai-Jin, did a combo, was able to get the medium kick, did the regular combo he was supposed to do, drops the combo, right, to build some more bar in the process, and was able to get one more confirm off a crouch medium kick into lunge punch, and he build that chunk of Gen-Ai-Jin.
So
literally a checkmate scenario, because if Chun-Li did reversal super, it wouldn't have worked. It's too slow. If she did literally EX SBK, Yun is too small. He crouches against the EX SBK.
Right.
So it was literally one of the decisions where You had to guess right on the crouching light kick or the command throw. Literally a life or death situation. Issei moving forward. But Chiriti, Canada Zone. We got to give a big shout out to Canada Zone. Chiriti for playing amazing right there, man. Such a good job.
But exactly how amazing both players were here for the highlight brought to you by PlayStation Tournaments. Again, a closer look as to what exactly went down between the Yun and the Chun. I could not believe that we saw an ending like that because of how sturdy and how active at the same time Chiriti's defense was.
I just think, how can people hate this matchup? After the matches that we just saw, it was just so intense.
Maybe they hate playing it.
Oh, maybe.
All the Yun players and all the Chun players are just like, oh, God.
Yeah.
But you really couldn't expect a finisher like
so
that.
So good. So good. Like, literally, when I was talking to Chiriti in Japan a few months ago, he talks about this matchup. Because I tell him, like, yeah, I'm very bad at this matchup because I'm very defensive. He says, that's the problem. You need to be more aggro. You need to be more active. You have to really just chase Yun down. Don't just think about building the bar, level, you know, this SA2 and everything like that. You have to make sure Yun doesn't get Genaijin. And I think Chiriti did show a good job, but Issei capitalized off of that and just going for more setups instead of, like, getting the clean hit again. Genaijin, going for the Genaijin when it's like half bar gone, because he's able to build so much bar every time, just recycle, and I mean, it really showed, especially in that last ending sequence right there.
Man, those enders were absolutely brutal. Not only the damage, but how significant that meter build is towards the ender. You have to be really cognizant with which ender you want to choose. And every time we saw the forward fierce ender to continue the juggle, you could see how impactful it was. Majority of the enders he built from prior to that, he's been building, what, maybe like a little over a third of the bar. But after the forward fierce enders, he built a significant amount, close to 50%. And at 50%, you only need like maybe a sequence and a half to get into Genaijin. And most of the time in those sequences, you're putting somebody in block stun.
Oh my God, you're completely right, because he gets the Oki after sequence, right? Could go for command throw, cross up dive kick, and guess what? Activate Genaijin Superman mode again.
Superman mode.
It literally is Superman
mode.
He
flies across the screen.
He does, right?
Yeah.
With the lunge punch.
Yun had a hard time getting in, all right?
Whoa.
No,
Who said that?
I'm not going to mention
Who said that?
Let me look it up just in case to see who quoted that after this break. I know we talked about the conclusion, but I'll tell you what. We need this moment to catch our breath, and I'm pretty sure Issei does as well. In the meantime, after this, we will have our champion for Third Strike.
Ready for the next battle with Tekken Points, exclusively from Chipotle. Use promo code EWGF623 when you order any entree in the Chipotle app and get 500 Tekken Points. Visit chipotle.com/Tekken8 for details.
Hey gamers, does your room look like this? Tired of having no art on your walls? You need displays. Made with high-quality metal and customized finishes, with Displate, you can transform your room or office from lifeless walls into a stylish space. Featuring officially licensed posters from your favorite IPs, like Street Fighter, Tekken, Mortal Kombat, and more. Say goodbye to hammers and nails with Displate's magnet lock technology. It never fails. It's as simple as snap and hang. Bang, bang, bang. Visit Displate.com/Evo and order now. Use the discount code EVO at checkout.
Damn, Kina!
Go ahead, take a picture. Don't stare, darling. I love good soiree. Looks can kill.
Okay, are we back? Are we back? Is the grand final time now? Damn, I just realized they don't have Dragon Ball at the tournament at EVO right now. I remember 2 years ago. I'm going back to that 2 years ago when I was staying in my hotel room. When I had a little staycation, I was watching Evo. It just so happened to be Evo weekend, and I was watching that Dragon Ball FighterZ Grand Final, or that whole damn tournament, lasted until 2 fucking a.m. Dude, I low key wanted to take an Uber down there and just check everything out. Is this grand final? No. Are we live? Is this live? I don't think this is live. God, I need to shit. Did I say that out loud?
New Fatal Fury. They might change it.
Well, I was gonna say, because even then, if you are in SBD mode,
no, SBG,
you can
special cancel out,
and then
it counts as a special.
And then you just
100%.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, for the moment we've been waiting for, the 25th anniversary of Third Strike. It is time for our grand finals. But before we get into that, let me hear you guys one more time. If you're having a great time out there, make some noise. Great time out there. With the legendary Justin Wong, to bring you guys quite the one of the opponents here, as we take a look at, has made the run of a lifetime.
Yeah, that doesn't work.
The character that he did
the count, pick, the counter
majority of the time. It's been the Elena. And
Teabag.
Face off against plenty of other characters in the tournament all day since. It's been so tough.
I just love the. I always felt like Elena was just like really good. And you know, it's just it's really the fact, right? But the thing is, she doesn't do too much damage just from combos. Her combo conversions is very, very low. It's all just kind of like this random one hit or quitters and everything like that. And you know, we gotta give a big shout out to Combo Fiend, because he's the one that really made Elena showcase in America the first time.
Come on. Oh my God.
Showcases how strong he 3-0'd Issei's Young. The fact that he 3-0'd Heil's Insane Hugo with Elena, not Chung Li, with Elena. We have to talk about Issei, because he is also an Evo 2009 Third Strike Team Champion. This was in winner semis and loser finals. Truly. Was just able to build meter. He's able time. He wants to be in good positions to activate, because he wants to make sure the 5 seconds really do count.
Yeah. He has a presence of mind too, to take a look at the life bar. Presence. The knockdowns. Afterwards is so. Look at the trick. Go back into. Is already lying in wait, but I gotta ask the question.
Okay.
If you're a fan of Issei, let me hear you. If you're. If you're a fan of MOV, let me hear you one time.
You know they like the Elena. I think they want to see Elena. They want to see something that has never been done before. Elena winning Evo. Elena winning one of the biggest tournaments. Literally the biggest fighting game tournament in the world. Think about this. This is crazy. This is grand finals?
It sure is, Justin. Keep your eyes peeled. It's Elena on the screen going against Yun. Issei versus MOD.
What do you think? What do you think Issei's game plan? Like, I feel like, what is...
EC have to do? Obviously, he's going to activate. Yes, but look, MLB is defending. Gets hit by the forward fierce, though. The big damage right there, side switch. Ooh, I like that. We haven't seen that the first time they played.
Right, yeah. A couple of adjustments taken from EC. All right,
here we go. Nice. Grand finals.
Okay, forward throw again.
Misses
the carry throw. Back throw, activate. Time to get maybe the main throw this time.
A little problematic from the side of MOV. He's already taken damage the first time.
Damn.
Second time
boom,
around,
boom,
he actually pays for it with his life. First blood drawn by Issei off of two Ganages in a single round.
I mean, he might get four in a single round. We might see.
Maybe.
MOV, what's he going to use? How is he going to get in? Going for the dash throw a lot more.
Ooh, that
nice!
Was
reactions? Okay, nice block on the overhead. Sweaty.
Super jump out of the way. Parry just in case. The Rhino Horn not going to be contested. Issei already knows to get out of dodge.
Yeah. Nice. All right.
We should hit that parry.
Over the scratch. Ooh, sweep.
Raw. Send it back.
Ooh, was a little too close.
Oh, that was a bait against the roundhouse. Activation time. Issei throws out a palm for safe measure first. Just to check it. And we wanted to throw out a
He's just stuck in the corner.
God.
Oh, man.
The low parry he knew?
How did you know?
Didn't spend the EX. The EX would have killed there. All right. Little hits. Safety though, meaty. Oh, he thought
Damn.
He had a super.
Dab. Oh, it's an
he
elbow.
Didn't have it. Unless he Squawk. Tried. By the way, that was an input error. It seems like.
Yeah,
it seemed like
could.
An input error there.
It possibly could. Either way, I think Issei getting away with it. The bait was proper, right? You wanted to try to bait your opponent out from using that meter, but the fact that he clipped was ever so dangerous because of the fragile health that gun has.
Oh,
yes,
that's the back. No, wait, no, it's not.
And also, I feel like
yes,
with
it is.
Kenaijin, he's
yes,
not really getting too much mileage. I feel like when Elena's clocking, it seems like she's.
I was looking at the dots on the TV. It looked like the background,
right?
Or like the reflection of the background, but.
And I think that's what's really changed the
matchup, I don't think it is.
Especially during the Kenaijin block mix-ups.
Man, all the way down to caught MOV in air. Man, the wake up.
Oh,
I don't even know if that was reversal. I didn't see it.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what.
Boom, boom, boom.
Bing. Hit agent.
Boom.
Hey.
Bing.
Hey.
Bing.
Hey.
Boom.
Hey.
Bing.
Hey.
Boom.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey. Look at the damage. He's
again saying, catches the landing.
Standing fierce. Tried thought the low parry was going to happen. Standing strong.
Folks.
Issei Coleman going to the second round with a full bar again. Agent already doing better compared to the winner's final set.
What a huge adaptation. Ganajin at the start of the round. Let's see how he chases down MOV, but it's MOV who escapes immediately, but
beam,
still gets a
boom,
chunk of
beam,
damage.
Boom.
Look at
Jesus,
the
what is
the dear lord, this man's a machine.
Back heavy kick again. Yeah, you can't do that. Even though the dive kick is negative, he can still hold up to do dive kick again. Look at the mix. Good block. Good avoidance. Defense.
MOV coming out unscathed up until this point.
Nice command throw right there. Nice. Terror throw right there. Defensive choice.
Again?
Sweep, roll, right?
The stage
oh
is
Oh my god,
cool.
That's a link! Level
Ooh,
one! That is a
that
lot
kills.
Of damage!
It's
Jesus.
Always towards the last part of the super.
Right? I think the crazy part is, normally if you're a Lena player, especially if you're like kind of like playing online, you usually go for Brave Dance. Brave Dance is kind of like the equivalent of Chun-Li's SA2, but using the level 1 for a faster activation time to land these overheads is
Bing,
so
bad.
Jesus, how do you block that?
You don't, you get hit by a command throw too.
Bing, 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 bing.
Right?
Nice, air to air, activate. You gotta land on the meaty. Crouching
trying to find
right
me,
kick.
I'm in.
Uppercut, what a call out from MOV. Sweep again, send it back, it's wrong.
Yeah, and he blocks the overhead. That overhead, it was gonna link into super. I already have 3 bars, nice tech on the grab. Yeah.
Damn, he made it work so much for him. Using
Whoa.
The EX upkicks, he made sure it
Whoa.
Counted also with all the damage. He's been going for that ender
Are they both from Japan?
Times as MOV jumps, and because of the fact that
hey,
Elena has
bet.
That floating jump,
don't
it gives Issei the time to punish it accordingly.
It's also like it's also one of those things that you do with faster, because even if he did carry the crouching punch, using the EX version of the upkick, faster plus juggle. You can combo afterwards.
Right.
Yeah,
you
so
lunge punch after.
Exactly. If MOV got hit by maybe the third hit,
this is match point.
Kill, lunge punch for the kill. But guess what?
Oh, this
we
is.
Are bringing
oh.
the queen of third strike. Strike. Ooh, boom! You can't say that if you're a young player. You can't say that if you're a young player, right? You agree with me, right?
Going into the character selection
okay.
right now. Chun, where have you been hiding?
So what is that?
This is something that we expected, right? MOV had talked about, no, you had talked about this regarding MOV.
Oh, no, it's US,
the
US,
situation
US
occurs,
in Japan.
You might see the Chun-Li come out.
But Issei, I mean, he's so good at this matchup. Like, he's one. It's one of
yeah,
those things
white
that, like,
shirt is from
if you're a third strike player, how are
USA.
You not going to fight against Chun-Li this many times? So the fact that I feel like Issei literally the ceiling of the character of Yun.
I'm in Hong Kong.
Going up. While I feel like the ceiling of Chun-Li, I don't see how it can go
people
up.
People trying to
here,
find me.
Right?
I mean, Hong Kong.
Ooh, again. Fans calling for reset. Just like that, how fast might this might be a 3-0, a quick 3-0? MLB needs to do something right here.
He doesn't have a bar to do it, by the way. That is such a great air-to-air. Going for the stop.
Oh,
that's
he got him.
About. Yeah, medium kick activation in
drop.
Two.
Oh, I love that.
That's very tricky, but great defense from Issei.
Okay, here we go. Go for the back fair. Issei's probably not going to activate here. Just because he knows. Maybe not. He wants to get the advantage.
He heard you. He's like, let me prove you wrong, Justin. I'm doing this for you.
Command throw? Nice. Hey. For the juggle. Look at that. Almost half life.
Yeah, that was a different enter than what he normally goes for because of how much time he had left, right?
Yep. Nice.
That is so
jumping
weird to me.
Back. We're not going to activate here. We're not going
to
activate here.
On to the next round. It's totally fine. Pretty much a mirror image. Of
oh, he's playing on a. He's playing on. Or he put his.
Now he's at two.
Bicycle on the chair, too.
Remember? Oh, maybe?
That's far, that's
yeah.
That's the way I would do it.
I don't know if it
that's just
going
to slide off my knees.
Super before the super flash. That's how. If you try to do super after the super flash, it will not come out. Ooh, nice. Meaty crouch, medium kick, MOB. Not biting against the dive kicks, but the activation station is here right now.
That was him walking up with crouch shorts over and over again. Yes. That happens a lot.
How did he recover that fast, though? And that's
boom,
a cross
boom,
up.
Boom.
Builds another bar. Standing ooh. Heavy kick.
You know for sure MOV attempted to go for the super jump cancel, but he missed it. And Issei absolutely loving that error, getting the punish for the reset. Ladies and gentlemen, I repeat, 3-0 reset. It's time to see who takes it in this final set. Between two legends.
It's so tough because, you know, MLB's game plan in winners finals was so solid. I don't really see what happened. I don't know what the adaptation is.
That's four out of seven.
Besides just like him not running into normal. That's like the only adaptation
NBA
I can
rules,
think about.
NBA
like he just stopped
rules.
Running into these pesky air normals, jump medium punch, jump heavy punch, forcing MLB to bring out Chun-Li. But even then, Chun-Li versus Yun, Issei just had the dominant run the whole entire day. Only it's one game.
Oh, no, it's a reset already.
Issei's warmed up.
It's best three
is MLB's Chun warmed up as well, too?
That is the big problem, right? He hasn't really had enough time throughout the entirety of the tournament all weekend. Primarily,
WNBA.
He's been focusing on Elena. So this right here, that could have been the wake-up call. Look at how active and how aggressive right now MOB is sitting at one bar. He's saying, we haven't seen a single activation, but we're about to.
Yeah, he just got it right here. Here we gonna activate, putting Chun-Li in a good spot. Yep, doesn't bite, it's gonna take the command throw. Good parry, you don't even know which side that's on.
That's actually crazy because there could have been an air catch, actually.
Exactly. Oh, what? Oh, that's
slow.
Right, Chun-Li. If you're blocking glow, fourth frame advantage
corner.
For Yun.
One touch away, technically from both.
Oh my god, what a read.
Right. He interrupted the shoulder. He did a heavier version of the shoulder.
Wait
that's actually the biggest snipe out
wait
for MLB in terms of momentum. What a call out against the shoulder.
Activate. Watch out for the back dash. Missed the activation
that was
right there.
Activation
yes.
That lunge punch.
Jumping back, medium kick, maybe air jump. No, he doesn't go for it yet. Oh my god. Okay, that's not too bad actually. Good parry
ooh,
right there.
Wait a minute.
Defense. Wow! Stand jab, crouching jab! It's a super! That's expert. Go for the carry throw.
It's so hard.
Misses the down parry right there. Tries to bait Yun. Pressing some buttons right there. Doesn't fall for it. Activation. What's gonna happen? Oh,
he missed the third one. Who would have thought the Fierce would have caught him? Issei did. Build up a couple of meters. He's already at 50%. EXSPK, get off of me. He tried to do it again.
There
he
it
still
is.
Gets
there.
The activation.
Wow,
the tenacity. He missed the execution the first time. That's why the standing medium kick came
exactly.
out. But he still managed to redeem himself in a split second. How do you even make that micro decision?
Oh, because if you're a Chun-Li player, you just mass craft medium kick.
Spoken like a true Chun-Li.
Yeah, I know. That's what I would do. Something doesn't work. If I mess up, I'm mashing my best button. It's so fast. I'm like not even joking with you.
No, and that's why I love you for it.
Yeah.
Okay.
My brain froze when you said that. I was like, yeah, that makes sense.
Let's go.
Even the announcer would have said,
yeah,
that makes sense.
That makes sense.
I think they they didn't
MLB
remove Dragon Ball
FighterZ
because they knew that it was going
to
go on for like
the back fears.
Hours.
I like the fact that MLB
again,
has
probably like until 4 a.m.
Really
and they have another.
Sure
the they have
the
a day
corner.
Three, brother.
Yun. No, never mind. Offensive throw.
Again.
Oh, back. Nice. I
love
that.
It's so good. That's such a great way to contest air to air if you're not quick enough to do the dive kick. Ooh, yep. Try to bait out perhaps an EX SPK.
Yeah, maybe. Or he doesn't want to activate.
That's not a low.
Maybe activate now, get some little damage right here. He's being greedy. He wanted that max damage. But, ooh,
oh,
good
parry.
Hey,
hey, hey, hey, hey, hey, hey.
Oh no, no Ford Fierce. Maybe the judge limit there? Oh, oh my god. Don't do it!
Oh, Jesus Christ!
Oh my god. I almost got flashbacks there.
Wow.
I almost said it. I almost said the curse 3-1.
Yeah.
Nice. The Justin Wong flashback.
I love that. Catching that. Okay, we gotta go for the reset. Nice crouching jab.
Would've been funny if Daigo was there
so
too.
So good. Okay.
There was an attempt, I think. Maybe he wanted to command grab to the very end, but MOB not even going to give him the breathing space. Jump back there just in case. Come MOB, trying to take to the sky.
Kick. Nice!
Ooh, he did.
Look at that health bar melt. It's like leaving a chocolate out of Las Vegas on the sidewalk. Insane!
That's going to melt.
Yeah, 10+ degrees.
Well, use the four fierce, maybe do the activation. MOB using back fierce to build some bar. Nice air parry right there. You can't challenge against that.
Minimal damage taken though, surprisingly enough.
That's a win. Nice!
Only time for him.
Issei, ready for the air parry. Super jump just upping forward. Air parry is on deck for both parties right there. Issei, look at that. He's making these air jump normals right here. Even just neutral jumping with not pressing anything. Focusing on what he's gonna do. MOB with the catch though. Reaction on the standing heavy kick.
So scary. One more. Okay, okay, here we go. Get AJ!
No! Parried it. To the second parry.
Parried it again.
Plus.
Help!
Hey, 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 hey!
Okay, lunge punch right there.
Miss hey, there's another command grab! A little bit of a walk-up crouch, medium punch, which up kicks as well! Oh, is he linking it? It's
hey,
a link!
Hey,
the link!
Hey,
that's so hard!
Hey, hey, hey!
1-1! Crouching medium kick activate into crouching light kick is literally a one-frame link. That's such a hard link to get. Manual
interesting
timing as well, too.
Interesting.
That is actually
interesting.
That is the most ridiculous thing to do on a grand final.
I'm going over there. Too lazy to get it.
How composed Issei is in this very moment.
Yeah, and you know, it's just like the fact that he gets the link, and even if he didn't get the link, he's still an advantage anyway, right? So he has so much confidence going into that scenario.
You see MLB just kind of like wishing Issei would, essentially. You saw the back of
Issei. Yeah, 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 yeah.
He's looking at him, he's like, yeah, I dare you to dive kick me from this angle.
Let's go, MOB. You missing the confirm on the crouching medium kick, possibly. Ooh, whip throws in the throw. Command throws. Activate. Gotta guess. Command throw right away? No. Issei doesn't want to go for command throws right away.
That's huge as well.
Go for the sweep right there. Okay.
I think it's the first time we've seen the sweep from Yun.
Yeah. Nice.
The my hair. Oh my god, so much meter built even off the block wall.
Again!
You have got to be kidding me.
Yeah.
That was not reversal timing, by the way.
You know what it is? I think maybe he's doing it because he's assuming Issei is going for a command throw or regular throw. EXSPK will blow up those throw attempts. Nice. Activate.
That was so
blocked.
Tricky. MOB held down back in the right direction at the very last moment.
Hey, 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 hey. Hey,
hey.
10 hit. Look at the feeder advantage right here. Builds again, Aijin. Wow, what an activation that is.
Overhead.
Really a statement. He wants to win this round. Yeah, that's cheap. Come on, that's how cheap is that?
Right, you have to block pretty much forever, and it's a throw.
Yeah.
It's a regular throw.
You ain't teching the throw there, and you just want to block.
Absolutely not. I wouldn't be super surprised if everybody did tech the throw, but...
Nice block on the crouching medium kick. Didn't want to bite there. Again, jumping out. Look at that. Man. Jumping out. Getting out of the corner for free. Using the parry option. That's right. You have to air to air. Just like that. Misses the back heavy punch. A little bit too slow there.
Ooh. Just at the boots as well. Dash up. Gen A, Gen A activation. Back throw. This is huge for MOB. He's stalling him for time.
Dude, he just
successfully defended.
Nice. Again. Doesn't bite on it.
Man, he pumped like three times.
He is. Stand jab anti again. Nice tuck on the carrot throw. Issei running away. Needs to build a bit of bar for the Genaijin. He got it.
Do it again.
Yeah, into the block string as well. A little bit of a gap, but it's so hard to contest.
Oh my god.
Damn, he read it.
MOB.
It's so good. He's doing such a good job. He's not going for crouch tech. He's going for stand tech instead. Again.
Jesus.
The air parries have been on point for both people. Nice jump out. Oh my god.
He could have activated it.
He's waiting. Look, he's in the little buffer. Activate. That's... Super. No, doesn't want to go.
Man, he just skips the screen like that.
Yeah, ice skating. Nice tech on the grab. Ooh. 20 seconds left. Nice. twice. Oh my god.
That was sick.
Yes.
Could have.
15 seconds. Standing fierce.
Damn it, I missed it.
MOB, that was intense. That might have been
Wide
the
layer,
most
what's
intense
up, man?
Round.
Thank you for the follow.
Third strike we have seen so far. You would think a Yun vs. Chun matchup, Rushdown versus like kind of a defensive character, going
so
down the
that?
Wire
two
to
game,
like
well,
20
two games
left,
to one,
activating supers left and right. It's just literally all so many decisions are made. So many parries are also being made right now.
Truly is a fight of a lifetime, man. These guys are at each other's throats when it comes to the ending parts of the round, because that's just how close they are in regards to like the back and forth. When it comes to, down to each and every round, it's like one hit away, essentially, with the inclusion of super arts.
Yes, of course. Right? Oh my god, MOB wants it. He smells it. This could be his first EVO champion. Third strike. The game that he really got famous for. Nice. Fight on the stand here.
So MOB could
like
win it.
Low parries. He doesn't want to mash. But Issei goes
right
for the forward parry right there. Misses the activation.
Oh, that's so rough. And
damn.
He spends the meter doing so with
damn,
the
ES punch
by accident. MOB now gets to control his face and build meter if he wants to, because he has the life lead, but also he has the estate behind him.
Yes.
He could backdash if he wants to, but it's up to Issei now to push the agenda.
Okay, walking forward. I love the fact that MLB is willing to just like, you know what, Issei, you can have the Genaijin. I'm confident enough that I can defend against it.
I mean, we'll see. He's master of the vampires, not master of verticality. Issei's been spending so much time airborne. Let's see if he can counter this Genaijin activation.
Ooh, the crouching jab.
Wow, that was kind of wasted.
He's ready. He is locked in.
It is so impressive to see MOB's movement in anticipation to what Issei wants to do, both airborne and grounded, looking for a way to get that activation going. It's Issei while building his meter.
Ooh,
he's going to have to do
dang.
It in the next round, ladies and gentlemen. Take a look at this. We're looking
dang.
At tournament point for MOB. However,
MOB match point.
However, Issei could build that bar up and turn it around.
He's about to jinx
he could,
him.
MOB,
he's about to jinx.
Issei needs to activate. Stand fierce. Can't raw activate right here. Look at this. All right, here it is.
Uh-huh.
Maybe walking back. Yep, jumping away from the corner. No hopping. No wall clinging. Whoa!
Oh, he got himself
over
in the corner.
The girl right there. Tech on both
That's
sides.
Crazy. My Street Fighter 4 brain thought that was going to cross him.
I know, me too. Nice. Forward throw again. Again, another forward
okay.
throw. We have meter. Activate. Do we link it?
Yes,
we
boom,
do
again. Hey, hey, hey.
The crowd is cheering. The crowd wants to see more games.
Oh, now he dropped it.
Drops the combo. Oh my god.
Uh-oh.
Back throw.
Danger
nice jump
zone.
Out. I love that.
Oh,
and
I was going to
so
say, I was going to say, is he going to come back?
The character model switch sides twice, and it was the cross up, ladies and gentlemen. Issei's fighting
thought
for his life.
Was going
to
come back.
About that dive kick. You have to do it in the
okay, go to a final round.
That's
get
exactly
that
it.
Rep, to get that
I just
jinxed
the shit out of
carrot throw right here. Standing rouse hit confirmed.
No.
This could be game. Maybe universal overhead. Low forward, meaty. And it is.
That's it. That is it.
EVO 2024 champion. He finally won. SBO four-time champion. He finally has his first EVO win. MOB with that Chun Li. Oh my god.
Wow.
He
somebody
finally did
Kim.
It. Claimed his
That's
throne
funny.
As the best Chun Li player
Woo.
In the world. The best Third Strike player in the world. MOB. He finally did it. Oh, he's so happy, man. He
complaining
is so
Elena the
happy.
Entire tournament run, by the way. Check the footage. Check all the footage of the times he was on stream. He played Elena every time. And man, what a feat.
He had to bring up,
man,
he had to break up
guys,
the Chun-Li.
Right?
Elena was not working for him.
We've seen him doing so well in so many tournaments. He really wanted to break out in games like Street Fighter 4, Street Fighter 5. And we've seen him going to all these tournaments around the world, doing the CPT thing. But guess what? The first time winning EVO, the biggest win, the game that he's known for, the game that like really people need to know about MOB, Third Strike, he's finally got it. I'm so happy for it. Even though he won SBO four times in a row.
That was great. That was a great grand final.
So this is his first time. I talk, he's like, I have zero EVOs. Guess what? You have one now. EVO champion for Third Strike in 2024.
Right,
can you believe it, man?
I genuinely could not, especially with the route he's taken with an alternate character. However, again, he had the confidence going into this prior to us being here at this table. He walked up to me, greeted me, and he said, don't worry, I got this. And I didn't
all right.
know what he meant by that.
Cool.
I didn't think he was first, but man, he had his plan.
All right, that was great. I don't think there's anything else going on tonight.
Out, he went to his
I think that was the end.
That definitely comes from the heart right here.
That is
100%. That comes from the heart.
It's from the heart, and it's really also uncharacteristic, because when you think about Japan Third Strike, you think about one main character.
Tekken's going to continue
right,
tomorrow.
But the fact that MLB, I feel like maybe he kind of exposed more Street Fighter 5, Street Fighter 6, needs to find a counterpick against characters like Yun, especially against characters like Hayao.
Yeah, Tekken's continuing tomorrow. I think everything's continuing tomorrow.
Somehow deep dive about this Elena, and it just really worked.
Damn, Mortal Kombat was today. Fucking missed everything.
She's a pool character.
Okay. All right, that's gonna do it for me today. I'm probably gonna watch like the Mortal Kombat tournaments off stream. But yeah, I will be back tomorrow for Tekken Grand Finals. I don't know if I'm gonna watch Street Fighter. Probably not. I'm mainly here now because of Tekken, because I missed everything else. But yeah.
Look at that, man. He was just doing so well. All right, I'm just gonna... with the adaptation of just not getting hit by Elena and like normals in general.
Is anybody streaming right now?
That really sealed the deal to getting that reset,
no,
right?
No, nobody's streaming.
Obviously, MLB has right. such an amazing
game. I'm gonna head out.
But I love the fact that Issei adapted.
I'm gonna get some rest.
Look at him, he said, boo!
And I will be back tomorrow.
That's the expression between...
Until then, I'm out.
Pretty much struggling against for
see ya.
Life.
It's the 5-5 matchup. This is the tale of old time. Like,